Series GTA San Andreas. Now, I know you're itching to bust out your gat, but keep it in your pants while we orient you around this game's enormous interactive environment.
It's 1992, and you've got vengeance on your mind. You're Carl Johnson, CJ to your friends, and you're the star of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
Hey, hey! Big Smoke! It's me, Carl! Chill, chill!
You're headed west from Liberty City to return home to bury your recently murdered mother and dig into your own tumultuous past.
Hey, I don't know why this had to happen, but I promise you, I'm gonna find out who killed your mom.
Like any hero, anti or otherwise, you face obstacles on this quest to find your mother's killer. From petty pigs...
Morning, boy.
Man, who you calling boy, fool?
Well, what should I call her?
To solicitous siblings.
Hey, she was my mama too. Not for the past 5 years, she wasn't me.
And power mad gangbangers. San Andreas presents a memorably unseemly menagerie of usual suspects.
Oh, mother.
Not that it's all bad. This sun-baked burg is all yours if you've got the guts to take it. Punch, kick, stab, shoot, jack. Pick your favorite violent verbs and go to town to explore San Andreas.
You're gonna have to walk now, sucker.
Taking a cue from RPGs like Fable, San Andreas wants you to work for your street cred by building strength and stamina to become leaner and meaner. But watch what you eat in this virtual world, or your character could hork like a famished fashion model. After training and feeding yourself to peak performance, go pick a fight with the gym leader. Once you've whooped his ass, he'll teach you more offensive moves you can take to the streets.
So pay attention and you might learn something.
In San Andreas, as in real life, it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that bling.
You're lucky my man isn't here, cabrón. That's as far as you'll get with me.
You'll need buku bucks for fly threads and all that glitters if you want to stand a chance with the honeys. The babes are more than just arm candy who offer the occasional dating perks.
Rogue King, baby.
They'll stash your weapons for you if you get busted and unlock secret outfits to wear around town, like the gimp or the pimp attire. For more special times, there's co-op mode, a new feature to the game, offering 5 free roam and 5 rampage missions throughout San Andreas. There are no rewards for completing two-player mode, other than the satisfaction of having shared something special with a good friend.
You're down with the grove and the ball is knowing, so watch yourself for now on CJ.
Yeah, yeah, for sure, you know that.
Is there a decent day spa in San Andreas? All that sun can give a girl laugh lines. Right now, it's time to help out our criminal friends using our crime-tested strategy to getting around in the virtual murder capital of the world. From petty crimes to grand larceny, here are some tips on how to have the skills to make the mill.
The best way to have a friend is to be one. And the best way to earn respect is to break into people's homes. Help your crew complete various jobs, and you'll also earn their loyalty. Yes, the gangsta lifestyle is thrilling at first glance, but it's also fraught with danger. And they have a lousy dental plan. Unless, of course, you rap about it and make millions of dollars.
Hey, yo, when I come through open the place, you don't want me to come with a gun in your face.
Help OG Loke jumpstart his music career by breaking into this house and stealing lyrics. Stealth is the key in the Mad Dog's Rhymes mission. Kill as many guards as you can, as quietly as you can, or you'll alert the whole posse and fail the mission. With most of the guards out of the way, it'll be easier to escape. Once you have the sheet music in hand, use the guard's own guns to carefully shoot your way out of the house to safety.
Holmes, you ice cold, dude!
In San Andreas, skill points are rewarded for constant repetitive use. You're encouraged to shoot, swim, and ride all you can. You'll earn extra points the more you use a particular skill. Tail Freddy on his PCJ in the OG Loke mission.
Ooh, chase me, chase me!
And put your riding skills to the test. Keep your distance or you'll lose them on sharp turns. But don't sweat falling behind. Just locate them on the map and take shortcuts to catch back up with Freddy. Once you reach the park, get off your bike and take them out.
It's the best you got.
Mowing down punks on your bike can earn you decent money, but I still have some reservations about the health benefits. Don't you get off the couch, because up next, we've got everything you need to make your way from Vinewood to Las Venturas and back without hitting traffic or drive-bys. Where rules are meant to be beaten like borrowed mules. In order to finish the game, you not only have to beat all the levels, but a handful of insane side missions to be the best. But it's easy when you know how.
So you ran all the missions in the main storyline.
That was a thrill.
Good for you, but don't pack that Gataway just yet, homie. To earn 100% completion rating in San Andreas, you'll have to beat all the required side missions, too. The vigilante, firefighter, and paramedic missions are all available, just as they were in previous GTA games. But other challenges await you if you've got the time and the skills and the willingness to play. Got a 40% cycling skill rating or better? Well, hop on your mountain bike and take the Chiliad Challenge atop of all places, Mount Chiliad. You'll pocket a cool 10 G's if you can truly dominate the downhill. Or maybe you'd like to earn an honest living for a change. After completing the 555 Wee Tip mission in San Fierro, take a turn as a car jockey at the swanky Venkerhof Hotel. Take your time and stay within the lines. The perfect valet parking job can earn you 15 bonus seconds. Beat all 5 valet parking levels, and the Venkerhof will become an asset of yours where you can collect up to $2,000 a day. Looking for something with a little more towing power?
You wanna fight, asshole?
Take a big rig gig to complete the trucking side missions. You'll be delivering cargo in your own semi. Of course, some of your merchandise is on the hot side, and cops may try to ram you off the road.
You wanna be a tough guy?
They'll be coming at you with full force on level 8, where you start out with a 4-star warning and have to cross half of San Andreas to make your delivery. Remember, the map is your friend. To complete this course, always plot your truck route in advance, or you'll lose precious time and be run off the road when the cops catch up. Instinct may tell you to floor it when the cops close in on you, but beware of jackknifing. Instead, hit the brakes when they get within spitting distance and watch the fun as they get knocked off. When you make your last delivery, the RS Halls will be yours, and you can pocket a fistful of Benjamins for your trouble.
I heard about this other hidden side mission where CJ sits in LA traffic all day and he really has to pee. Doesn't sound very exciting. But now that you know your way around, you're ready for some real fun with the cool new cars and weapons at your disposal in San Andreas.
For all its colorful characters and amazing scenery, the hallmark of any GTA game is the things that make you go boom. Just like its predecessors, San Andreas has enough weapons and vehicles to make The Matrix Reloaded look like The Sound of Music. Don't be late for Molotov Cocktail Hour in the Burning Desire mission. Officer Tenpenny wants you to torch an apartment building controlled by the vicious Vagos gang.
There's a guy holed up across town. You got that address, Blast?
When you're on your way to the apartment, run over the 3 hoods out front with your car. Then get out and gun down the rest of the gang members out back.
Welcome to America, asshole.
Keep your distance from the target as you toss the cocktails, or your friends will start saying you're some kind of flamer. It's a good strategy to secure the area by taking out any stray punks before you firebomb the remaining windows. Don't worry if your aim isn't all that it could be. More Molotovs will appear in front of the house. Or just enter this cheat code to add this and other weapons to your inventory. that doesn't light your fire, enter this sequence to further up your arsenal. The Vagos gang won't know what hit them when you use these extra weapons to finish out the mission and make a new friend.
Hey man, I owe you my life.
Like any fly hoochie, Denise knows a good ride when she sees one. Enter this cheat code to impress her with a totally pimped stretch limo when you take her home.
Okay, I'll catch you later, CJ.
If you like to get down and dirty, use this code to spawn your very own Trashmaster garbage truck. It's just another way to clean up San Andreas. Or hit the links in this custom caddy cart. Go for it, Tiger. But perhaps the most coveted ride of all is the Rhino Tank. It's only available once you finish the game with 100% completion, or when you cheat and enter this super secret code. Go ahead and take it out for a test spin around downtown. You won't be disappointed.
Impressive if tanks are your thing. My weapon of choice, however, is the Withering Look. Here, watch. Feel that? For a recap of those codes, check out the Cheat Sheet Master Database at g4tv.com/cheat. Now I'm off to buy some malt liquor and some bullets. Fortunately in San Andreas, they're in the same aisle at the mini mart. Be right back. Welcome back to Cheat, where practice is a four-letter word. So maybe you're busy, or you're late for work, or your meds haven't kicked in yet. Whatever the reason, you just can't seem to find the time to settle into playing an entire level. Get a quick fix with GTA's dozens of exciting mini-games.
With 100-plus missions and dozens of side quests, the world of San Andreas should be enough to keep any gamer busy. But you're not just any gamer. Help keep CJ in fighting form with regular visits to gyms all across the state. Depending on the location, he can bench press, do some curls, ride a stationary bike, or spar in the ring. What? No Pilates? Pimps up, hose down. It's time to get to work. Escort Abel DeSoir to her evening assignment in Los Santos, or any other district where you'd like to establish your pimpin' cred. It may look like fun, but pimpin' ain't all fur hats and champagne. Some Johns may want to play rough, and it's your job to protect the merchandise. That's your number one priority. Max out your pimping skills at 10, and the ladies will reward you with some nasty lovin', in addition to a generous cut of their cash.
Girl, that was truly something else.
If peddling flesh isn't quite your speed, check out the Lowrider Challenge for some good, clean fun.
You looking for the lowrider meat?
Visit the Unity Station in Los Santos to pit your lowrider against other cholos. Your reward depends on what you're willing to risk and how good you are at what basically amounts to a miniature version of Dance Dance Revolution on wheels. Now bounce your lowrider to the beat. The highest score wins.
All right, the homie, let's see if you got what it takes.
Fortunes are made and lives are lost in the casinos of Las Venturas. This Sin City atmosphere is the place where blackjack, roulette, poker, and other diversions await the adventurous types.
Hey, Mr. Johnson, just a friendly reminder that you owe me money.
Be careful how deep you dig yourself into debt, or the casino mob bosses will take it out of your hide and collect with your life.
You should have ran away.
On a more wholesome note, get some fresh air and go for a run on Saturdays and Sundays with the Triathlon Beat the Clock Challenge at Santa Maria Beach or Fisher's Lagoon. You'll need your swimming and cycling skills in peak form for these contests. Now get ready to swim, run, and ride your bike. This exercise essentially consists of repeatedly pushing the X button. If your character and your thumb can last, the take is a cool 10 Gs.
You want
You ever start to think that all this cheating is somehow wrong? Yeah, my ex-boyfriend didn't think so either. Breaking the rules gets the cops on your tail, so here's some more cheat codes to help you clean up your rap sheet.
City life is exciting for sure, but it ain't all beer and Skittles. You've got drug lords to deal with, girlfriends to manage, and John Law to dodge.
Read right there.
Sir, I fear you're making a terrible mistake.
The only way to survive in a town without pity is to cheat. Granted, bashing other buckets and their motorists is half the fun of life on the road in GTA, but you'll want some skills behind the wheel. or your wanton ways could land you in the hoosegow. Enter the cheat code on the bottom of your screen to lower your wanted level and ditch the fuzz. Whether your job is selling insurance or busting caps and punks, commuting can be a major drag. Why waste time traversing all those big bridges back and forth when you can just enter this fun cheat code, which lets you hover over the water in any four-wheeled vehicle? And just think what you'll save on tolls.
Okay, we got the bikes, and Woozy taking care of the uniforms.
The obstacles in San Andreas get tougher as you progress, testing new skills as soon as you acquire them.
Why don't we steal one while it's on its rounds? That way we can make some money, too.
You're up against government soldiers, trying to stay alive in the mission up, up, and away. Take out the first four guards as soon as you enter the compound. Stick to the side as you enter the warehouse and take out the ground troops first. Are you wounded? Enter this code to score full health and armor, plus a cool $250,000 in cash. Bust a move for the rooftop, taking out the guards around the copper. Now use the turret gun to take down the two gunships that have been sent in after you. Then deliver the truck and reap your reward.
All right, dude, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all later.
Ooh, San Andreas rhymes with Dr. Zaius. I'll have to remember that for my creative writing class. Okay, if you've forgotten all the cheat codes we just showed you, head on over to the database at g4tv.com/cheat. Up next, come fly with me as I show you how to hijack the Hydra. Keep it where it is. Welcome back to Cheat. No shirt, no shoes, no service. Say you've jacked every ride in San Andreas twice, and you're looking for more. Well, there's always a handful of missions left to be done. Late in the game, you have to take to the skies with your very own Hydra. That is, it's yours once you take it from the military.
Just when you thought you were out, they pull you back in. You're doing another job for Mike Torino in the Vertical Bird mission.
Torino?
Listen, you gotta pull one last
strike. Hold up, Mike. Okay? Hold up, 1 second.
Time to sit the gate, Carl.
I'm tired of this, Torino.
And with only 7 more to go, this won't be an easy one.
You just gotta steal a military jet off an amphibious assault ship and use it to destroy a flotilla of spy ships. Nothing big.
Once you're inside the ship, make your way to the SAM controls on the second level and take out any guards that get in your way. Once the SAMs are deactivated, head for the Hydras. Blow up the two planes closest to you before heading for the third. That way, you'll only face one enemy once you're airborne. The Hydra's controls are sort of a cross between a helicopter and a plane. The right stick controls the thrust vectors, so hit down before you take off, or you'll roll off the deck like this. You'll have other Hydras on your tail once you're airborne, so have your weapons at the ready. Use R1 to establish a lock and L1 to fire the missiles. Once you take them bad boys out, go after the flotilla of spy ships. Take your time, they don't shoot back. Once you've cleared the airhead for Verdant Meadows and park your Hydra in the hangar, you'll collect $50,000 in reward money, and the Hydra will now be accessible from this airfield.
Let me give you a little tip. Don't pay for a headset. The in-flight movie usually sucks anyway. Who says eggs are just for Easter? They're always on the menu in San Andreas, if you know where to look.
We live in an imperfect world, and so do the assorted lowlifes in GTA San Andreas.
Oh, shit.
Where getting over is all a matter of knowing the angles.
Now I got to steal another car. Right?
Here's how to turn the game's glitches to your advantage. You'd make a great vigilante, if only you didn't have to chase down all those damn criminals. Work this glitch for a lean-back vigilante experience. First, acquire a police vehicle, either a cruiser or a motorcycle. How you do that is up to you. Next, head to a building which you can enter and exit. Activate vigilante mode before entering and chill for a spell. After 15 or 20 seconds, you'll get a target eliminated message. Now you can hop back on your prolonged ride to activate the next level. You can repeat these steps as often as you like, but it can sometimes take a few trips to eliminate the target. CJ gets his armor boosted to 150 after level 12, and we got as far as level 22 before we began to yearn for some more meaningful employment.
Have a wonderful day.
Who says you gotta go to flight school to get a pilot's license? Okay, besides the FAA. The skies are never friendlier than at the Los Santos International Airport, where earning your wings is as easy as hopping the fence and stealing the Shamal, a Learjet-styled plane. Take her up for about 30 minutes and look, up in the sky. You're suddenly a licensed pilot with access to all airports. Say you're in San Fierro and you're looking for some eggs. Head over to Gantt Bridge and check out the first tower. Right at the very top, you'll find a sign that says, "There are no Easter eggs here. Go away." Wow, that's really deep if you think about it. Elsewhere in San Fierro lies a little diner in the shadows of the massive Gantt Bridge. Here's where you'll find everything you ever wanted to know about the bridge, from how many polygons it uses to how much disk space it takes up. Yeah, but can you buy it? Too bad they didn't make it destructible. Meanwhile, back in Los Santos, check out the billboards for some sly digs at rival SoCal gangbanger game, True Crime Streets of LA. There's also a billboard for Vice City's favorite porn star, Candy Sucks. Candy isn't the only character from a previous GTA game to make an appearance. During the cutscene to the mission Woozy Moo, you'll find the main character from Grand Theft Auto 3 hanging around in the background.
I think you're getting high on that country air, man.
And that's it. I'm dry. What more do you people want from me? Got a question about your favorite game or a hot code you want to share with another player? Visit the message boards at g4tv.com/cheat or send an email to cheat@g4tv.com. For a recap of all the codes, just check out the Cheat Sheet Master Database. Until next time, I'm Kristin Holt, and I'm a cheater.
Welcome to Cheat, your daily dose of tips, tricks, and codes. I'm your host, Morgan Webb, and for the next 60 seconds, we'll be turning the bullet-riddled world of GTA San Andreas upside down with two cheat codes that'll strap you into a jetpack and undress your fellow citizens. One of the biggest obstacles in San Andreas is the sheer size of the city, so it takes forever to get anywhere. So why not cheat your way into a jetpack? Enter this code and you'll be flying around the city like a low-budget Iron Man. Oh, I'm gonna die. Sure, you're on a mission to find your mother's killer, but why pursue righteous vengeance when you can objectify some women instead? Enter this code and everyone starts sporting bikinis. Stay tuned to G4 for more cheats, tips, and tricks, or visit our website at g4tv.com/cheat. I'm Morgan Webb, and you've been cheating.
Welcome to Cheat, your daily dose of tips, tricks, and video game subterfuge. I'm Kristin Holt with another 60 seconds worth of NPC tormenting cheats for Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories on the PlayStation 2. Make sure to enter the following codes at any time during gameplay. Feeling lonely driving in your stolen vehicle? Friends don't want to ride in your hoopty? Use this code and the nearest pedestrian will jump in your ride to keep you company. And you thought M. Night Shyamalan has a big head.
I see your face!
Enter this cheat and everyone's head will have a newfound twist.
Don't hate, congratulate, Leia.
For these cheats and even more codes and tricks, watch G4 and visit our website at g4tv.com. I'm Kristin Holt, and you've been cheating. Hey gamers, I'm Kristin Holt with another minute's worth of tips, tricks, and cheats. This time out, we're gonna pimp your ride in Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories on the PlayStation 2. Who needs chromed out 22-inch rims when your whole car can bling bling? Enter this cheat and every vehicle will be pimped out with an all-chrome paint job. Now, if only they can make your ride bulletproof. And speaking of rims, if you're in the mood for some bigger wheels, or even smaller ones, enter this code and the tires on motorcycles will go from mini to massive. For these cheats and even more codes and tricks, watch G4 and visit our website at g4tv.com/cheat. I'm Kristin Holt, and you've been cheating.
You see, in Odd World, there's two kinds of gamers, my friend. Those who play the game right, and those who cheat. Coming up next, we've got a fistful of Stranger as we take a look at a bounty of game-busting cheats for Oddworld Stranger's Wrath. You dig?
cheat, where playing by the rules went out with the mullet. I'm Kristin Holt, and tonight we're off to Oddworld, where a mysterious bounty hunter known only as the Stranger is on the prowl. Just who is this weirdo, and what does he want? Is bounty hunting really the best way to make a living? And why are there so many chicken people running around? We cornered Oddworld creator Lauren Lanning for all the answers.
Well, Stranger fits into the Oddworld universe in a different way than we had done in the past. And in this game, we wanted to stake out some entirely new territory in terms of gameplay, but also in terms of the species and the heroes that we're creating. And we never saw ourselves as the Abe and Munch Company as much as the settlers of Oddworld. And so Stranger was a perfect opportunity with the new gameplay style that we wanted to do, which was much more action-driven, to just go into a different location. The story for Oddworld Stranger's Wrath was inspired by, on the surface, the Sergio Leone character of the Man with No Name from, you know, those great spaghetti westerns. We felt that that inspiration was very appropriate, you know, for what we wanted to go after. And we wanted to start off with a character who was very concerned with himself for his own motivations and had some various issues happening. And we wanted to, the bounty hunting theme was a very natural theme for gaming. The bounty missions are at the core and the heart of who our character is and what his plight is and how he raises the money to, you know, when we really see how the plot thickens. Bounty hunting and getting those enemies and those end bosses is it's right at the core of the game.
Jump cash in time.
To be the best bounty hunter, you'll need to know how to fight. Keep in mind, there's more to the Stranger than meets the eye.
Stranger in general has three different types of melee attacks, and two of those are physically based when he's could be standing still or walking or even moving faster, which is, you know, left and right trigger. He'll do like a melee swing punch, and then he can do a headbutt. And the headbutt is like, it'll knock characters out. It'll do more damage than the swinging one, but you can't move as fast when you do it. But his primary one is that if you keep on, you know, heading him in one direction, he'll increase in speed and he'll go through different gates in his animation. And as he increases in speed, and once he starts to lope, which is sort of a little hint that there's more to the character than meets the eye, once he starts to go into this sort of cat-like loping role, he's moving faster, but he feels more like a motorcycle in the way that you control him. And we wanted that because one of his key melee abilities is being able to ram into characters.
The Stranger's melee attacks aren't his only abilities. This game has a new engine that combines first-person and third-person action, taking it to a whole new level.
We wanted to break through a few barriers, you know, and we really felt like the boundary between first- and third-person action hadn't really been cracked with very strategic differences of how you would play both, but allow you to play either at any time. The strategic difference between first and third person is that in first person, you're bound by about 15 miles per hour and how fast you can move. If you choose to go into third person, you can't shoot, though you do have melee abilities, but you can run at 55 miles per hour, which is faster than all the other characters can run. So that allows you to get into a tense situation and go, I'm just hightailing it out of here. But and that was pretty ambitious, just to say, well, we want to crack the first to third person barrier, and it was pretty challenging, but ultimately, I think we succeeded pretty well.
Okay, so the Stranger is hiding something. Is he good, bad, or just plain ugly? What did Lorne mean when he said there really is more to the Stranger than meets the eye? While you ponder that thought, I'd like you to meet some dear friends of mine who want you to buy stuff. Of course, they're only my friends because they pay my salary. We'll be right back.
Mom, Dad, this is my boyfriend, Jinwoo.
Jinwoo.
Konnichiwa.
Who's this?
This is Jinwoo.
Woo, huh? That sure is a fancy phone.
You called it a phone? I told you he wouldn't understand.
Oh, honey!
It's got MySpace Mobile!
Oh, honey!
It's actually a Helio.
Don't call us a phone company. Don't call it a phone.
Hey! Yeah, I had pan pizza on my anniversary. Well, I burned dinner. I mean, I burned dinner.
The original pan pizza from Pizza Hut. Now $10.99 for a large, any way you want. Add any medium one topping for $5 more. Pizza Hut pan pizza.
It used to be this was the only place I could use my phone. Right up here, by this window. But now, with the Sprint network, not only can I watch live news on my phone, but I can actually use it where I want to. DP here.
Switch to the Sprint Power Network. Now backed by our 30-day risk-free guarantee. Sprint.
Hey, guys, look at this. With Sprint's new fair and flexible family plan, unlimited night calling starts at 7 p.m. Isn't that great?
Honey, you are so clever.
Oh. You're the best dad in the world, Dad.
I love you, Dad.
Oh.
So?
I'll take the plan. Thanks for letting me use Sprint's practice family.
Glad to help.
I'm gonna take lunch now.
Only Sprint's fair and flexible plan gives your family unlimited calling starting at 7 p.m. for no extra charge. Available on Sprint or Nextel.
You look gorgeous. Can I get
at
you for a second?
Just did. Bye.
For four friends.
Why you call me Shelby?
I'm taller than you.
One summer changed everything.
When we're out on that rink, nobody can touch us.
ATL. Buy it Tuesday on DVD.
I'm Kristin Holt. Our rule-spanking exploration of Oddworld Stranger's Wrath is well underway, but we've only just scratched the surface of this massive universe. Like any good bounty hunter, the stranger needs to have plenty of live ammo on hand as he hunts down the outlaws. But in his case, that ammo is not only live, but kicking and screaming.
Never liked guns.
Stranger may hate guns, but that doesn't mean he won't kill an outlaw to make a few bucks. To round up bounties, it doesn't just take melee moves, but a double-barrel crossbow armed with live ammo. It's actually live critters that you round up throughout the game. There are 8 different types of ammo, including chipmunks, which you use to lure enemies to you, fuzzles, they're like live landmines, and boom bats are just like grenades. These feisty creatures will literally take a bite of any outlaw or innocent townsfolk that crosses your path. And what's even better is the ammo is upgradable. How you use these different critters in different combinations offers unique strategies in how you play, whether it's running wild with your crossbow blazing or using a more stealthy approach. Keep in mind that every character you meet can be taken out in different ways as you use the destructible environment and your critters. Now we've got some live ammo combination strategies from the resident gamers at Oddworld Inhabitants.
With our weapon system, one of the main advantages is it pauses the game, so you can choose kind of your strategy before you enter an area. I like the skunks and the bees because you can essentially suppress guys, a group of guys, and then get them with the bees, which is very machine gun-like, and take them all down.
One of the best strategies you can use, obviously, is to use a chipmunk to draw an enemy away from his friends, and then use a bolomite to wrap the enemy up, and that way you can bounty him and get him alive. If you want to be a bit more, a bit more creative, and also necessarily care about bringing guys in alive, scattered throughout the game, we have a wide variety of traps. So what you can do is use the chipmunk to maneuver guys near fans or these cranes, and then you can use things like the thud slug, which can knock guys around. My favorite weapons, I love the boom bat and the sting bee. It's a great combination because you see a group of targets and you hit them with the boom bat to scatter them or outright kill them. And then in the ensuing chaos, you let them have it with the sting bee.
Now that you know more about the live ammo system, we've got a major piece of advice for the stranger when he's out searching for the next bounty.
With the stranger, where there's one game speak button, it's context sensitive. So if I'm walking around and I hit that button, I can talk to myself and I'll just go, need to find a bounty store.
Gotta head north, they're wagons.
Really what's happening is your mini goal is being told to you by the character anytime you want. And if you talk to someone else, it's relating that mini goal as a question to try and give you more information.
Can you tell me how to get to the next town?
What? Is it hard to find your way with your head up your butt?
But what I really like to do is just talk to all the characters because there's some really unexpected humor that gets delivered. And if you're just rushing through the game and you don't talk to the characters, I think you're really missing something. So that's one of the things I would encourage, because there's a lot of little sort of Easter eggs waiting within these characters and what they have to say.
You want directions, punk? Piss off.
So we have over 5,000 recordings of just those little game speak snippets built into the game.
I can't help you out, really, but I can tell you my pants are way too tight.
You know, the Department of Defense is actually at work on a gun that can shoot thousands of golden retriever puppies a minute into enemy territory. How cute would that be? Who'd want to fight with all those little puppies running around? Well, no matter what you're packing, every outlaw has a big bad boss that you need to track down. And when you do, the bounty will be worth the trouble. Here's one you'll meet early on in the game and all you need to know to rope him in.
Stranger, you ain't taking me!
Now, when you get to the actual bosses, the outlaws, he's going to have a unique playstyle. He's going to do something different that the other guys don't do. And then you'll have to figure out how to deal with your live ammo system and do this to really maximize getting that guy in the way that you want, you know, dead or alive.
Here's our strategy for the third mission at Gizzard Gulch, where you've got to Bounty Boyle's booty. He's storming through the town with his gang to rescue his brother Blisters, who you captured in the beginning of the game. Once you're out on the streets, the battle begins. Boyles and his boys are already firing, trying to pin you down. You're gonna have to use the back alleys of town to your advantage. First, run to the trailer by the west gate and take cover so you can load your crossbow with boom bats and fuzzles. If you've got a clear path, start running in this direction towards this fence and crash right through, taking cover in the back corner on your left. Set fuzzles along the fence and on the wall. They'll attack, giving you a heads up of when the gang is closing in, and now toss in a boom bat to blow them all away. Head for the back alleys at the east end fast and take cover. This is a good place to take a break from all the crossfire and recharge your health. Shake off the damages by pressing the Y button. While you're recovering, Boyles and his boys will be coming to you in full force. Set more fuzzles and blast them with the boom bats. If you need more bats, run over to this alley with the critter crates and stock up fast. Before you can bag Boyles, all the other outlaws have to be taken out first. And when they're all gone, Boyles comes out even meaner with his gun blazing. Dodge his attacks and fire back with thud slugs and fuzzles. They'll keep biting, bringing down his health fast. Here's the time to decide if you want to bring him in dead or alive. But after all the trouble he's caused, we're choosing dead. Now say adios to Gizzard Gulch. You're moving on to Buzzerton, where there's more moolah and more bounties.
Knocking them good.
My boss treats me the same way, but she's not so easy to kill. At least I can take out my frustration on those cute townsfolk of Buzzerton and make some moolah while I'm at it. For a recap on the boss battle at Gizzard Gulch, head to our website at g4tv.com/cheat, where you'll find all the strategies you'll need. Next, we'll introduce you to Explosives McGee and show you how to bring him down, plus FaceTime with some other Oddworld inhabitants.
When America needs a hero, when freedom stands alone, let us join Special Agent Bob and Secret Agent Steve, two of the finest official unofficial splinter cells.
Would you stop that?
What?
That. Stop that. You're doing it on purpose.
You're doing it on purpose.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Grow up.
Seriously.
I like the pork donkeys.
Dude, that's sick.
I hate you so much.
Whatever. You're the donkey porker.
Start talking.
I just take care of the monkeys.
Really? My partner works with donkeys.
Not right now.
You guys have a lot in common. You could go on a double date with your respective animals.
I hate you. Wow, this game is fun. Look, a priest.
Oh, don't talk to him. He's Shadow Spect, and I hate Shadow Spect.
Dude!
Sorry, but those guys are donkey porkers.
Stay tuned for the continuing adventures of Bob and Steve.
New longer-lasting juicy fruit. Sweet.
Dude, I wanted that.
Yeah? And?
Don't rest you for it.
Gotta have sweet. Gotta have longer-lasting juicy fruit.
From the director of X-Men and X-Men 2, the legend returns. Superman Returns, rated PG-13. Now playing in theaters and IMAX.
With our new Super 6 mix, the possibilities are endless.
So I could get a large pizza, wings, and a mini bike?
No.
Cheesy bread?
Yeah.
Puppy?
No.
Domino's new Super 6 mix. Choose three or more great menu items for just $6 each. Get the door. It's Domino's.
There are two ways to define function.
Feed your appetite for fun with Butterfinger Crisp.
Yeah!
Butterfinger Crisp. Follow the finger.
Go to GameTap, where you can play hundreds of the greatest video games from the greatest systems right from your broadband-connected PC. You can play everything from classics like Pac-Man and Sonic to current favorites like Tomb Raider, Splinter Cell, and more. It's the easiest way to access over 500 of your favorite games, with more games added every week. And if you sign up today, you'll get 2 weeks free. There's no long-term commitment required. And GameTap TV takes you beyond the games with funny and original shows you can watch whenever you want.
Oh, great.
What?
I hate level 3.
In seconds, you can be dodging missiles, fighting aliens, and who knows what else. Experience the new world of video games. GameTap. Expand your playground. Play to win the ultimate entertainment prize pack. Sign up at GameTap.com/enter for your chance to win. Some games rated E to T, not all games rated by the ESRB.
Working from home changed my life.
It all started when I was referred by this free service.
With all the money I made working from home, I bought a new home. This is the one website you have to visit.
Put your computer to work now.
All you need is a computer and a little belief in yourself.
I'm making $5,000 a month.
I make over $7,000 a month working part-time.
I love the lifestyle my home business offers, and the money's great, too.
Log on to OneGain.com now.
Hi, I'm the person who didn't save hundreds of dollars by switching car insurance. Yep, I'm the guy. Must be, because every day they tell me about a bazillion people who switched on TV, radio, billboards.
They show me entire stadiums worth of people who switched.
But Progressive Direct shows you side-by-side comparisons of competitors' rates and services, so you can see if their services are worth the savings. Those gazillion people should call Progressive, because no one likes to be wrong. Think easier. Think Progressive.
Oh, we're back with more ethically questionable Oddworld shenanigans on Cheat. Now that you've met all your live ammo companions and you know your way around Oddworld even better, it's time to dig into some serious strategy with more battle-tested tips from the folks at Oddworld Inhabitants.
So this is the halfway through the Explosives McGee minecart level. Explosives McGee is this boss who's in Mongo Valley, is mining for native artifacts and gold and, you know, things of value. And he's essentially set up this crazy minecart system to get his goods in and out. This is where you take a big, huge spiraling minecart ride down and all these guys chase you. I'm gonna get in this minecart and show you one of the big advantages of this level that you can take. So in this level, you see a bunch of explosive barrels. Usually the player won't, you know, fight and blow these things up, but if you just go ahead and blow all of them up, it gives you a huge advantage, and this is like a good cheat. So now you're getting chased by this guy. Another thing you can take advantage of in this game is the menu system will pause, so now I can switch tactics, and I decide to go with the boom bat. And with one boom bat, I can blow up anybody who's chasing me. Again, we see like a bunch of barrels. If you just blow up these barrels, then you're gonna take out a bunch of NPCs before they can even come and fire at you. Now you'll see all these outlaws will come out, but they have nothing to walk on. So it makes stuff a lot easier for the player if you just blow up the barrels beforehand. So instead of even trying to fight this guy, I'm just gonna blow up the barrel, because then he falls and he dies. These two guys are chasing me. I could fight him with the bees, but that takes quite a bit of time. I'm just gonna switch over to the boom bat and just destroy them and their carts with one blow.
When you reach the end of the minecart ride, you'll have to make your way towards Explosives McGee, fighting a wave of more outlaws on the ground. Once you reach Explosives himself, watch out, because he's got a six-shooting, body-rocking grenade launcher and a posse of minions that are ready to take a bite out of the stranger.
And his boss fight's actually interesting in that he spends the entire fight in a minecar, and he moves around on a rail above you, trying to hit you with rockets. So what you have to do is strategically dodge him and hit these switches that causes his platform to drop further and further down to the ground so you can get access to him. And all the while, you have to watch out for, like, he'll send waves of minions after you, so you have to strategically watch out for his minions, dodge his rockets, and also keep an eye out for when you have to hit the switch to knock him down.
I ain't dead yet! Bring it on, sucker!
It really is more satisfying to bring in those bounties dead than alive. And one more bit of advice. If you run into trouble, you can save your game anywhere, anytime. As big as Oddworld is, there's still more to explore if you know where to find it. With a little help, we discovered a secret level in the game. A quiet part of town where you can slip away for a quick and easy upgrade.
If you kill your search carefully in the game, though, you can also sniff out a black market. Now, black market offers more significantly enhanced upgrades to your various critters and live ammo. The black market is located in a town called New York City, which you'll get to when you get to a section of the game called Mongo Valley. If you listen around, this lady's talking about cool stuff for bounty hunters.
You need to climb that rope across the street to find.
So you look around for a rope here. This is the rope she was talking about. I climb up here, explore these rooftops, follow this path back here, and lo and behold, a door.
What's the password?
Mole's ass.
Close enough.
I'm in the black market. So now you can see he has all kinds of stuff. He's upgraded spiders that can purchase. He's got upgraded, for your first-person melee moves, you can purchase spiked knuckles. You can also purchase different enhancements for your speed, stamina, as well as extenders for your various weaponry, give you more ammo. It's a fun thing to find.
And now that everybody knows about that part of town, it's only a matter of time before they build a Gap and a Starbucks there. But Oddworld could use a good cup of joe. Coming up next, we're getting close to the end, but with some more help from Lauren Lanning, we'll ensure that you make it out alive.
Cheesy goodness. That's snacking strong.
At what point does a car do more than take you from point A to point B? When does it come to life? When does it become your co-conspirator? When does a car become more than just a car?
Introducing the all-new 268-horsepower Toyota Camry. It's time to move forward.
His movies have explored the dark corners of our fears. Now, he reveals the nightmare that waits in your own backyard.
Oh my God.
M. Night Shyamalan's Lady in the Water, rated PG-13.
Get what you want with Dell. Like this Inspiron B130 notebook with an Intel Celeron M processor for just $479. Dell, purely you.
Sundays are high octane on G4. Bounce with Big C on Street Fury.
This is my baby.
Why your baby getting on me like that?
Then get smoked with Formula D.
The action's about to heat up.
Sundays, it's Street Fury at 6 and Formula D at 7. Presented by Scion, only on G4.
In 8 days, for the first time ever, the world's biggest comic book movie and animation convention comes to you
live.
G4 presents Comic-Con 06 Live.
It is indescribable.
On the floor with 100,000 fans.
I'm totally geeking out.
Bringing you breaking news, interviews, and events
as they happen.
Plus, one of the most anticipated films of 2007.
It's a Transformer movie exclusive.
Comic-Con 06 Live.
Presented by Yaris.
July 21st at 8, only on G4.
Welcome back to Cheat's Adventure Through Oddworld. We're almost at the end of the game, and we still haven't figured out what it is the stranger is hiding. Of course, you could work through all the final levels on your own to find out, or maybe we can get Lorne Lanning and his guys to spill the beans. Is there such a thing as a secret that's worth keeping?
Well, wait till you get to the last third of the game. It really changes. But as we start getting into the industrial environments and we start sort of escalating beyond the Western theme, and what you find in this game is that what starts to, and begins to feel as a Western, by the time you're done, that's just completely gone. You're in a whole nother, flavor.
With the world changing around you, there's a major plot twist thrown in too. Remember when I said there's more to the stranger than meets the eye? Well, too bad we can't show you what I'm talking about, because it would really just spoil all your fun. We may be cheaters, but we still know how to play fair every once in a while. Instead, I'll just be a tease and give you a sneak peek at some of the later levels and toss in a little strategy for good measure. This is where all those live ammo tips and stealth strategies will be put to good use.
This is the Wolvark docks. It's this level takes place a little later in the game. So in this level, as you can see, there's these huge crates that are hanging, and essentially you can use these crates as traps. One of the upgrades to your weapons you get is the howler punk. The howler punk will lower many guys into wherever it is launched. So for example, I'm gonna launch the howler punk underneath this crate and lower a bunch of guys, and you can see them coming in your radar, which is a great advantage. So we wait for these guys to come under, and then you can activate the crate and they all get crushed. So I just killed four guys very simply. So that's a good tool to use. So these crates are definitely a big advantage. You can see, like, I haven't even taken a hit.
Now, you might be thinking, are there any cheat codes in Oddworld Stranger's Wrath?
There are, but we're waiting to let those out. The type of unlockables that we have in the game are, if we gave them to you now, they would break the experience for you, because it'd be like infinite ammo, upgraded ammo in the first level, infinite health, level cheats, things of that nature. So we're being careful to not really reveal those things until, a good percentage of the people who are gonna play the game have actually played it, and then that'll offer them some new ways to play it.
Well, Lorne might think that having some cheat codes will ruin your experience, but we think that cheat codes is the only way to play. But since Lorne wasn't talking, it's a good thing we know where to look and who to rough up in situations like these. I only had to catch and bounty 10 Oddworld inhabitants for the information, but it was worth it. Here's what I got them to cough up. When cheating your way through Oddworld Stranger's Wrath, there's a few extra steps to entering the code. You'll need to have a second controller handy. To enable the cheat codes, plug in a second controller in port 2, and then take it out and continue with the following sequence you see below on your main controller. Once that's all done, you can enter in these next codes to cheat through the game. Give the stranger more moolah without rounding up a bounty or harassing the locals. Just enter in the code on the bottom of the screen and you'll be rewarded with 1,000 moolah. Use the code again and get 1,000 more. If you keep it going, you can afford to buy all the upgrades from the start. You can make the stranger invincible when you enter in this code. Now you'll survive every gun battle and every fist fight without a scratch. With cheat codes like these, capturing bounties won't be much trouble at all.
That was the first time anyone got to see these cheat codes, but unfortunately that's all the time we have for today's show. And as the sun sinks slowly in whatever direction it sets in on Oddworld, it's time for us to say goodbye. Are you stuck on a level and need some help? Then send up a flare to cheat@g4tv.com. You can sound off about the show on your message boards and check out our cheat sheet master database at g4tv.com/cheat. That's where you'll find all of the stranger's cheat codes, and the strategies will be there too. Until next time, I'm Kristin Holt, and I was born to cheat, baby. I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is the Evil Covenant is back in Halo 2, and they're bent on destroying the Earth. The good news is we've got the scoop on every dirty trick you'll need to blow their brains out. So stick around, and let's cheat together. Well, Welcome to Cheat, the show that proves cheaters never win until they press up, up, left, left, and jump to enter God mode. This time, we're earning our wings, making sure you don't have to take an early dirt nap playing Halo 2. We captured Bungie insiders and tortured them with an energy sword till they dropped the dime on Halo's spruced-up weaponry, hijackable vehicles, and Xbox Live capability. What's that? What's an energy sword? You need this show more than you think, my friend. Master Chief gets some fresh rations for his return to the Xbox, including a family-sized can of whoop-ass. Help him serve it up to the Covenant and save Earthlings from extinction in the totally immersive, wicked-fast Ramjet Halo 2.
Our goals were more about creating really memorable places. We wanted to make missions where you could really tell where you were and why it was important to be there. Well, we went through a lot of effort to make sure that every level has unique and special things about it.
With a fan base that makes Trekkies look blasé, Bungie could have slapped together any old sequel and still outsold its competition. But never content with even their best, they bumped up the graphics engine and poured on the texture mapping to make Halo 2 the coolest looking Xbox game ever. You'll love every pixel of the game's fancy new look, especially when you get your hands on new marine weapons like the battle rifle, SMG, and a retooled Magnum pistol. Of course, the Covenant bad boys have some new iron too, including the carbine, beam rifle, fuel rod cannon, root shot, and I gotta get me one of these, the energy sword. Also notice cool new abilities like dual-wielding weapons, which can make for some devastating combo moves. And if you like the look of that ghost your enemy's riding, take it. You can also hijack vehicles this time out. Have the Bungie boys been playing GTA on their break time? Of course, love is nothing till you give it away, which is why Halo 2 is Xbox Live enabled.
We built our Xbox Live component as a system link game. So we have this system called Party Invites where you can send a party invite to up to 16 friends and they join together as one cohesive unit, almost like one player. And they can move around on Xbox Live and play other teams. If you want to go check your statistics, if you want to go look at your clan, if you want to set up clan events, if you want to find out what's going on with the game, if you want to look at maps of the game you played last night and find out where you were killed, you can go to bungie.net to do that. You can find out detailed statistics about yourself and anyone you ever played. It's going to be a massive part of the game going forward.
You ever notice that old school guys like James Bond only use one gun, whereas new action stars use two? I guess it's because 007's enemies try to fight him with their stupid razor hats, while more futuristic foes tend to tear it up with dueling plasma guns. Anyway, in the always cutting edge Halo 2, you're invited to double your pleasure by dual wielding certain select weapons. Check it out.
You know the old saying, it's not the size of your weapon, but how many of them you have that matters, or something like that. The point is, you're now twice as deadly thanks to Halo 2's dual-wield weapons feature. First off, not all weapons can be dual-wielded. Only the plasma pistol, plasma rifle, needler, SMG, and magnum pistol work together in combination. But do the math, that's still plenty of punch. Learning which combos to bust out when is half the game. When combining weapons, consider the different properties. An energy weapon like the plasma rifle works well when coupled with the SMG, which can pepper your target with explosive projectiles. Going up against an elite, knock out his shields with the plasma burst and then make him dance with a little SMG fire. The plasma pistol is another handy piece of ordnance, especially at close range. Charge it up and use it as you would the plasma rifle. Then finish the job with either the magnum pistol or the SMG. What's that? You say your magnum's empty and you left your SMG in the ladies' room? Never fear, whip out the needler. It's a great projectile weapon in a pinch, unleashing a volley of smart homing needles. Just make sure to keep a lock while you're firing, and the little stingers will do the rest. Okay, Covenant, you ready for a piece of this?
Stay with the Master Chief. He'll know what to do.
Okay, you dirty cheaters. Time to recharge your energy shields and reload your needlers. Or just grab the last snack pack from the fridge before your brother eats it. Whatever you do in your downtime, hurry back, because next up, we're going to walk you through some deadly levels and reveal the location of Halo's ultimate weapon.
Go to Game Town.
where you can play hundreds of the greatest video games from the greatest systems right from your broadband-connected PC. You can play everything from arcade hits like Pac-Man and Sonic to modern favorites like Tomb Raider, Splinter Cell, and more. There are over 400 games, with new ones added each week. And if you sign up today, you'll get 2 weeks free. There's no long-term commitment required. And GameTap takes you beyond the games with funny and original shows you can watch whenever you want.
Oh, great.
What?
I hate level 3.
In seconds, you can be dodging missiles, fighting aliens, and who knows what else. Play now at GameTap and experience the new world of video games. GameTap. Expand your playground. Play now and get 2 weeks free at GameTap.com/now. Some games rated E to T, not all games rated by the ESRB.
Welcome back to Cheat, the show where you're losing only until your opponent looks away. We're taking you through Halo 2, and next you'll find out how to turn more coats than Benedict Arnold by playing as either the Human or the Covenant. You know, I've been dying to see what goes on in those steamy Covenant shower rooms after a firefight. So send me your pictures from your camera phone, okay?
Sick of saving your fellow man from destruction? Switch sides and play as a Covenant elite in Halo 2. In the Oracle mission, you are the Arbiter.
What would you have your Arbiter do?
A disgraced elite who is blamed for Halo's destruction. The Prophets dispatch you to a mining facility to kill the heretic leader. In the first laboratory, you'll meet the heretic leader, but only in a holographic form.
I wondered who the Prophets would send to silence me.
And soon after, you'll be reintroduced to the pesky Floods. Clear out the Floods in the lab and move on to the elevator. In this section, your goal is to basically stay alive until the elevator reaches the bottom floor. Here, the Sentinels will be trying to kill the Floods and all foreign organisms. That means you. Take them down when you have a chance, and use their Sentinel beams on the Floods as well. The best weapon to fight off the Floods is the Energy Sword. Use it against the combat forms, and it will leave nothing for the infection forms to bring back to life. Once you reach the bottom, continue until you reach the second laboratory. There will be a small group of heretics fighting the Floods, so just let them kill each other. Once it's quiet, jump down and clean up the place. The doors to get out of the lab won't open up until all the Floods are eliminated. It doesn't get any easier as a small group of heretics will storm the lab, but a couple of well-placed plasma grenades should clear your way. Make your way across the bridge and eventually into a large hall. Here you'll find the heretic leader, but that coward is hiding behind an energy screen.
This will save me from the storm, but you will be consumed.
We shall force him out. How? A cable. I'm going to cut it.
Work your way up to the elevator and engage in combat only when necessary. Once you reach the top, cut the cables from the three corners. Once the mining facility begins its free fall, head back down and chase the heretic. After flying your Banshee to the next station, the only thing that separates you and the heretic leader is the Flood. Make your way through the blue-colored doors and up the ramps. When you reach the hangar, prepare for a showdown.
Arbiter, I would rather die by your hand than let the Prophets lead me to slaughter.
He'll create two holograms of himself, but you'll only need to kill the real one to finish the mission. A frontal assault here means instant death, as you'll be outmanned and outgunned. Use cover when possible, and use the energy sword's lunge attack to knock down his shield and finish him off.
I had no choice, Holy Oracle. This heretic imperiled the great journey.
Scarab gun. It just sounds badass, doesn't it? Well, if you want to test drive the universe's ultimate tail toaster, get your pen ready. There's only one way to find the game's most powerful weapon. But be warned, this is no walkthrough in the park.
For a limited time, get the amazing Scarab gun. It slices, it dices, it gets rid of unsightly nose hair, and still blows your enemies halfway to hell.
See this one? It's terror!
Now, how much would you pay? But wait, this amazing Covenant weapon can be yours free if you follow our secret pathway.
We've all run the simulations. They're tough, but they ain't invincible.
Start off on the Metropolis level and eliminate the Marines that board the Scorpion. You'll be glad you did. Cross the bridge as you normally would and destroy all the ghosts and wraiths that you encounter. When more Marines join the fight, though they are your own guys, take them out as well before reaching the end of the bridge. Then, take out the Banshees that attack you, but leave one in the air. Also, make sure to hijack a ghost before entering the tunnel. Lure the Banshee into the tunnel by shooting it periodically to keep it interested. When you reach the first barriers, take out the Warthog and the Marines, or they'll destroy the Banshee. Continue to lure the Banshee past the second barrier and eliminate any Covenant resistance. You'll notice the Banshee will get stuck in corners repeatedly. The best way to get it out of the corners is to stand behind it and walk backwards until it retargets you. This will save a lot of frustration. The hardest part of the whole process is to lure the Banshee into the small tunnel. And through trial and error, you should have the Banshee in this position. This is the part where you will either succeed or cry and start over. When you see loading done, immediately board the Banshee. If you inadvertently trigger it without boarding, then the Banshee will disappear and you'll have to start over. But if you're able to board it, then pat yourself on the back. You've done it. Navigate it out of the tunnel and fly toward the twin bridges. In the middle of the first bridge, you will see an orange cone, your holy grail. Swap it out or dual wield it. You now have the most powerful weapon in the game, the Scarab Gun. Special delivery for the Covenant, and it ain't no candy gram.
Hey, whoa, put the Scarab Gun down. It's me, okay? Trying to give a girl a heart attack? I was gonna tell you how to find a bunch of human skulls, but I think I need a minute here now after having my life threatened. Watch these commercials. Can I get some water over here? In news that's rocking the music world, rapper Proof was shot and killed. The member of Eminem's D12 crew was gunned down outside a bar on Detroit's famous 8 Mile Road. Proof's real name was Deshaun Hilton, and he was the inspiration for Mekhi Phifer's character in 8 Mile. International soccer superstar David Beckham could be headed for the United States. Mr. Posh Spice hints that he may sign with a U.S. team after his contract with Real Madrid expires next year. And finally, in a first for the Emmy Awards people, nominations for online and mobile content have just been announced. Major networks, productions like MTV's Stand In and Fox's cell phone series 24 Conspiracy did top the list, but smaller shows like It's Jerry Time also got the nod. All right, guys, that's all you're getting from me. For more on today's top stories, visit g4tv.com/the feed. Welcome back. Sorry about that, you just freaked me out a little bit. Anyway, on a lighter note, is there anything more amusing than watching two rival parties of the same species blow the crap out of each other with plasma and needle guns until they're just smoking needly corpses? I didn't think so. Luckily, that's just what you get to do in the next level of the game, the Grave Mine.
What is that?
I am a monument to all your sins.
Ever wonder what happened to Audrey 2 from The Little Shop of Horrors? Well, he spawned himself into the future as a self-proclaimed bad weed with an orb that sounds a lot like C-3PO.
Greetings. I am 2401. I am the monitor of Installation 05.
We received a reviewer request from Master Chief JR1 for tips on how to complete the mission Gravemind.
Kill the demon.
Once you start the mission, there will be two honor guard brutes in the chamber. The quickest way to take these big monkeys down is to hit them constantly with the needler weapon so it creates an explosion. Once you kill a brute, the other one will go into a berserk rage.
They don't have shield generator. It's berserking.
He'll begin his charge attacks, so jump out of the way when he gets near you and repeat your offensive attacks. Eventually, your attacks will bring him down. Take their plasma rifles and get ready for the next wave of enemies.
Truth is moving through the lower levels of the tower. I'll reverse this grav lift.
As you make your way down the corridors, take full advantage of all the corners and doors around you. Playing hide-and-go-seek with the Covenant will shield you from any further attacks, giving you enough time to regenerate your shield to full strength. Now finish off the rest of the enemies and make your way down to the next level.
Here, Chief, jump in.
Here, Cortana orders you to free Marines held captive by the Covenant in the lower levels.
I'll be right at our patient. You neutralize the guards.
Take out the big brute in front of you and take shelter anywhere safe to regenerate your health. Take out the rest of the jackals and grunts in the area and free the captive Marines in these cells. Once you free the second wave of Marines in these holding cells, make your way back up the grav shaft to the next area. The same cast of characters will appear in this area and are easily killed until you meet the hunters. You can try to take out these body-armored aliens but that'll just get you killed faster. Make like the Flash and just run right past them, and the hunters won't even get a shot off. Hit your next checkpoint and move on. Once outside, you'll find a battle raging between the Covenant and the Heretics. It's a good strategy to stay out of their way, because eventually they'll kill each other off. Take out whoever is left and move on to the next stage. The place is now crawling with enemies from both sides looking to take you out. Take refuge in any corner or corridor to keep yourself alive, and stock up on any weapons the enemy leaves behind. Fight your way through, and you'll make contact with Cortana, who will give you more information about the Prophet of Truth.
I'm picking up two more transponders. It's the Commander and Johnson. They're closing on Truth's position, Chief. They'll need your help.
Congratulations! Mission complete. Make your way across the bridge behind the mausoleum to finish your objective and to rendezvous with Johnson and the Commander, who have now been taken prisoner by the Covenant.
Next up, you'll learn where to find Halo 2's nifty collection of skulls. Why do you want skulls? Hello, to drink the blood of the vanquished out of. Am I talking to myself here? Actually, they make legendary mode even harder.
Throughout every mission, there are secret Easter eggs in the shape of human skulls that can change the physics of the game, like the Sputnik, which will send your enemies back to their home planet. And if you look closely at one of them, you can see strange numbers on the back of their heads. Most of the skulls in the game are only accessible when played on Legendary, but the Blind Skull can be found on any difficulty mode. Begin the mission outskirts by heading towards the hallway with the flashing light. Once inside, turn right and look up. Jump towards the halogen light, then turn right and crouch jump to the rooftop. Make a left and you'll find the Blind Skull at the end of the passageway. Once you pick it up, it'll make your HUD and yourself disappear, making it a lot more difficult to target the enemy. The next skull can be found in the beginning of the Armory mission. When the Sarge appears, don't get in the elevator quite yet. Wait for him to say this line.
Would it help if I said please?
Now get in and take the elevator up. When you get to the tram station, walk to the opposite side of the doors and press up while holding down the X button. The skull will be on a stack of green crates near the end of the ride. Once you pick it up, the skull will make the Covenant more aware of your location, making them the champions of hide-and-go-seek. There are plenty more skulls to be dug up, so send us an email to cheat@g4tv.com to let us know which ones you find, and we'll add them to our Cheat Sheet Master Database.
I don't know about you, but all those skulls are making me hungry. Hang out here a minute while I go shoplift some munchies and a strawberry milk. When I get back, I'll show you the game's greatest glitches and give you a peek at the big boss.
If you will give me some time.
G4 coming to you live from E3.
Believe it or not, I'm watching E3. I never thought I'd get in so easily. Watching G4 in my beautiful chair. What will I see?
Live coverage of E306 coming in May, only on G4.
Why, you no good, low down, dirty, yellow, cheating scum. Welcome back. If there's one thing I love, it's taking advantage of the weak. That's why I'm so psyched about this segment, which will show you how to manipulate the flawed fabric of the game itself via its glitches.
In Halo 2, fragging your friends over and over in multiplayer mode can get kind of boring. Good thing there are cool glitches to wipe away the boredom. To make Master Chief fly faster than a speeding bullet, select any level where there's a Warthog and Banshee vehicle. Line up the passenger side of the Warthog to the back end of the Banshee. Get in the passenger side of the Warthog and lock on to the other player by pressing the right trigger. Once you've locked on, have the other player fly as far away as possible in the Banshee ship. When you get out of the Warthog, you'll immediately fly towards the other player. Now properly thank your friend for giving you a copy of Superman 4 for your birthday. Also, create an aerial ballet with the Scorpion tank as you launch it into the air with the greatest of ease. In the mission Delta Halo, destroy the shield generators on the ground and park the tank over them. When the shield regenerates, it'll send the Scorpion a mile high. Ever wondered how hard Master Chief's head is? Well, take your plasma swords and have one player jump on top of the other player's head. while targeting the top player, have the bottom player repeatedly press the X button and the right trigger as the top player jumps up and down. If done correctly, you'll be able to reach new heights.
Okay, now I'm going to spoil the whole game for you. God, I'm so happy. At the request of my very favorite viewer, you know, what's his face, the guy with the shirt? Yeah. I'm going to show you the last level of the game. No, seriously. So if it destroys any semblance of joy you could have taken in playing Halo 2, please blame him.
Our long voyage is at an end as we answer another viewer request. Rocco E is looking for hints and strategies to defeat the final boss, Tartarus, in the mission The Great Journey. Here, you'll play as the Arbiter as he tries to stop the Halo from being activated. Most of the objectives in this mission are relatively simple as you jump from one vehicle to another to find him.
The Hunters have come to our aid, Arbiter. They will fight by our side.
Stay close behind these Hunters and use them as your 400-pound linebackers. They'll open up holes in the enemy's defensive line, giving you a clear path to the goal line. You'll find your toughest challenge in the objective Delusions and Grandeur. Only an army of brutes stand between you and 50 hours of self-imposed seclusion. The best strategy to pacify these primates is to use your plasma grenades and sword. Throw the grenades at the brutes so they stick to them, giving you a sure victory, and wield your sword for closer combat.
Put down the icon. Put it down and disobey the Hierarchs?
There are things about Halo even the Hierarchs do not understand.
In this final battle, the Arbiter is aided by Johnson and other elites loyal to him. Tartarus is surrounded by a force shield that protects him from any attacks, and he also wields a large hammer that'll inflict a lot of damage on you, so keep your distance. Stand back and let your allies take down his shield. Only after a melee of offensive attacks will Tartarus' shield finally come down, making him vulnerable to any weapon for a few seconds. Stay in visual contact with him and watch for his shield to dissipate, and eventually you'll bring down the Covenant's captain.
Quick, while his shield is down!
This is Spartan 117.
Can anyone hear me? Over.
Isolate that signal. Master Chief, you mind telling me what you're doing on that ship?
Sir, finishing this fight.
All right, my felonious friends, we've crib-noted our way through another episode and didn't get caught. Remember, if you run into a roadblock in your favorite game, don't whip your console through the TV. And whatever you do, don't practice. Instead, visit the message boards at g4tv.com/cheat or send an email to cheat@g4tv.com and we'll help you out. For a recap of everything you've seen today, check out the Cheat Sheet Master Database. Until next time, I'm Kristin Holt, and I'm a cheater. You know what I've been thinking, my little cheating chum? You need to get a life. Well, a half life anyway. Hey, it's still a 50% boost in the amount of life you have, right? So stay tuned. Welcome to Cheat. I'm Kristin Holt. This time, we're grifting our way through the gritty and unusually exciting life of Gordon Freeman. Yes, the hero of Half-Life 1 is back, and once again, he's going to have to drop everything to save the world. Seems like I've heard that one before. Of course, with all the roided-up evil aliens and juiced-up weaponry in this stunning sequel, old Gordo's going to have to be even bigger and badder to deal with the Combine hordes.
Rise and shine, Mr. Freeman. Not that I wish to imply you have been sleeping on the job.
Wake up, boys and girls. If you haven't been sleeping under a rock for the last 5 years, you'd know that Half-Life is one of the most acclaimed first-person shooters of our time. Now Valve, the game's developer, finally released a highly anticipated sequel. At the end of the original Half-Life, Gordon Freeman was given a choice by the G-Man.
They have authorized me to offer you a job. Otherwise, well, I can offer you a battle you have no chance of winning.
Well, it's more like a one-sided choice. After accepting to work for the G-Man, you disappear from existence until you are awakened to find yourself on a train bound for City 17.
The right man in the wrong place can make all the difference in the world.
Due to the dimensional rift caused by the Black Mesa incident, planet Earth has been overrun by an alien race known as the Combine. A peace deal was brokered by former Black Mesa administrator Dr. Wallace Breen, and now he serves as a puppet figure for the alien occupiers. He can be heard spewing his illogical rhetoric throughout City 17.
Immortality is in our reach.
With all civil liberties stripped away, the Combine's oppressive ways have forced the remaining human populations to live a subservient and meager existence. Oh. It isn't until Gordon Freeman's arrival to City 17 that a revolution is sparked among the few remaining resistance fighters. Here, you'll find the few surviving members from Black Mesa, such as the absent-minded genius Dr. Isaac Kleiner and your buddy, the super security guard, Barney Calhoun. Not to worry, there'll be others you'll come across that will shape the fate of humanity. You may think a great story is important and all, but what about the weapons? It is a first-person shooter after all. You have your standards. Pistols, shotguns, machine guns, and rocket launchers. But how many games do you know that have the zero-point energy field manipulation device? It's more affectionately known as the gravity gun. This is one of those weapons that can do it all, and I mean it, it can do it all. You can use it to pick up objects and shoot it at your enemies. This is extremely handy because it'll save valuable ammunition. Pick up a solid object and use it as a shield against oncoming fire. Then there are puzzles in the game built just around the gravity gun. Don't be fooled, this isn't your standard FPS. You'll need to use your brain and Twitch skills to finish this game, and that's why we're here.
Got all that? Good, because it's gonna be on the test. Of course, you always seem to do really well on my tests. I wonder why. Anyway, if you go steal a car or something during the break, make it quick. In the next segment, we're going to walk you through some of the game's toughest levels and teach you how to find your good friend, the G-Man. G-Man, I like that. Maybe I need a nickname.
Drop in anytime. Sweet, tart, I hate choosing. Let's not, shall we?
What's that?
Not what? Why? Why, it's new Sweet Tart Squeeze. Sometimes inventing candy is hard. Sometimes it's squishy. A fine addition to the Sweet Tarts family. New Sweet Tart Squeeze. Why not give your candy a... Ask your parents if you can play Sweet Tart Squeeze Tag at wonka.com.
I had a dream that my whole world was blue. A royal Xanadu. The world was so bright.
I was stuck, not really knowing what to do with my life. One day I was watching TV and I saw an ITT tech commercial and decided to make an appointment. I'm a network center tech, providing customer service at one of the largest telecommunications companies in the nation. At ITT Tech, I gained an education in electronics with really good instructors. It was the best decision I've ever made. After graduation, I was married and started my career. Through hard work, I was able to afford my own home. My wife can stay at home and raise our son, and I have another baby coming on the way. Having an education has broadened my accomplishments, and every morning I wake up knowing that it's just the beginning.
We are educators helping people build a foundation for the rest of their lives. ITT Technical Institute, education for the future. Call 1-800-327-1172 or visit us on the web. Get an education that can help you reach your goals. ITT Tech has information on financial aid programs for those who qualify. Call 1-800-327-1172 to apply.
Hey guys, welcome back to Cheat. Kay Holt here with the skinny on Half-Life 2. You like the nickname? No? Too much? Okay, I'll work on it. While I do, get hip to the intricacies of the water hazard chapter and learn the location of Black Mesa East. I hear it's like way hard to get a table up there, so listen up.
The Resistance has just given you an airboat, and all you have to do is make it through the water hazards to reach Black Mesa East. It may sound simple, but the Combine is hot on your ass. That's why we're here to get you through the tougher spots. When you've reached the first blocked gate, get out of the airboat and head inside. Here you'll find Dr. Breen spewing his rhetoric. Is he talking about you?
And yet unsophisticated minds continue to imbue him with romantic power, giving him such dangerous poetic labels as the one free man, the opener of the way.
The one free man. I like the sound of that. After you've had enough of Dr. Breen, continue on until you reach an open area with a machine gun nest on the other side. Use the barrels as cover and toss a couple of grenades to flush the enemy. Once he's out in the open, take him down. The next room is manned by several Metro cops. Toss a couple of grenades inside and finish off the rest. Head up the stairs until you see the control for the gate. Looks broken. Ignite the barrels to your right, and the gate is open. It's time to backtrack to your airboat. That Combine dropship you saw left a welcome party. Man the machine gun outside and quickly mow them down. Once you're back inside, use the vehicle as cover and shoot from underneath. Use your grenades to take down the hard-to-reach guys and mop up the rest with your SMG. Get back on your airboat and move on. You'll need to foot it when you reach gate 5. Head for the dock and go inside. Be sure you pick up the .357 Magnum and save it for later. Make your way through the shipping containers and be wary of the Hunter Chopper's cannon fire. Always stay out of its direct fire. Once you've reached the warehouse, pull out that Magnum and let the fun begin. The gun's single-shot kill eases the pain in this area. Take refuge from an elevated position and take out the guys coming into the warehouse. When you've cleared the area, use some boxes and get yourself up to the next platform. Work your way through the rest of the warehouse until you're back outside where the Hunter Chopper is waiting for you. Make a run down the concrete walkway to the control room. Go up the ladder and quickly take out the guards. Grab the machine gun. It's payback time. Lay some smack down on the chopper until it leaves the area. Don't forget to open the gates before you leave. Get back to your airboat and continue through the gate. The waterway is now more dangerous than ever. More Hunter Choppers will converge on your position and they will start dropping mines in front of you. If you're taking a beating from the mines, then head inside this red warehouse to recharge yourself before moving on. When you've reached the canal dam, you'll face off with a Hunter Chopper. Put some fire on the chopper as it closes in. Make sure to clear out the explosive barrels that are floating in the water. Once you're able to do enough damage to cause the chopper to smoke, it'll attack even more viciously. The chopper will start dropping a nearly endless stream of mines. Shoot at the middle column when the chopper flies over you, and you'll be safe from the explosions. Continue this tactic until it takes a faceplant into the water. Go through the floodgate. You've made it to Black Mesa East.
Elusiveness is a trait we cheaters greatly admire. That's why we're such big fans of the G-Man, the sneaky sucker who keeps tabs on you throughout Half-Life 2. In this next segment, we'll tell you where to find Mr. Man and all the Easter eggs he's got in his little basket.
When you're busy killing the Combines and freeing the citizens of City 17, you just don't have the time to take in the finer details and hidden secrets of the game. We're going to show you where and when the G-Man shows up and a hidden Vortigaunt who needs a couple of cough drops. The first G-Man sighting occurs in Dr. Kleiner's lab. After Barney finishes at the terminal, flip through the monitors. You'll see the G-Man standing there briefly before turning and walking away. When you're running from the Metro cops in City 17, you'll come across members of the Underground Railroad in a red train carriage. As soon as you're inside, take a close look at what the Vortigaunt is watching. In the Water Hazard chapter, zoom in on the man standing on the pier in front of Station 7. The G-Man will watch you briefly, then turns and goes inside the building. Not too far down the waterway, take a look at the giant flickering monitor that is attached to a building. One of the images is that of the G-Man. Later on in the Water Hazard chapter, while dodging bullets and barnacles, the man makes another appearance on a small gantry in front of the second covered bridge. Towards the end of the rail yard in Ravenholm, get yourself on top of the trains, and you'll just get a glimpse of a man in a gray suit walking into the train tunnel. At the beginning of the Nova Prospect level, flip through a couple of screens on the monitor, and you'll see the G-Man peering through the window. Our final location occurs in the Anti-Citizen 1 level. Right after Dog takes a ride on a Combine dropship, head inside the building where you'll find the G-Man starring in his own TV show. Besides locating the guy in gray, we also have an Easter egg to show you. In the Water Hazard level, once you've successfully taken down the Hunter Chopper, head over to the two sewage tunnels. Park your airboat in front of the left one and head inside. Here you'll find a Vortigaunt with a sore throat.
We cannot forget those whose cords you cut.
Talk to him and he'll just talk and talk and talk and talk and talk.
The bright face obscures your darker mask. But we will persevere. Kalamba kalilama.
Now, I know we've given you a lot to remember, so we've lovingly cataloged all the information on our website at g4tv.com/cheat. Next up, you'll learn how to manipulate gravity in a multitude of ways, so stay tuned.
I'm Layla Cayley, your own personal British newsreader. Now on your mark, get set, feed. He's already remade Planet of the Apes and Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and now Tim Burton has set his sights on a video game. The rumor is Burton will be tackling the big screen adaptation of Grim Fandango. You know that LucasArts game about skeletons? Well, it's right up Tim Burton's alley. The French government is finally doing something cool instead of just surrendering to Germany or not invading Iraq. France will now be given computers and a high-speed internet connection to low-income families for only €1 a month. Not even the poorest people in town can enjoy surfing for porn all day long. And that's today's feed. For even more news and info, check out g4tv.com/thefeed. Those guys are busy updating all day long with the stories I didn't even have the time to get to. So do yourselves a favor and check it out. Now put down those crack Pringles and say no to drugs because you just been fed.
Did I scare you? Ooh. This is a great place to watch a scary movie. You should try Vongo.com. For less than $10 a month, you can download all the scary movies you want. You even get your first 14 days free. Of course, if you prefer comedy or drama, Vongo's got it. Look, Vongo's new. Sometimes new things are scary, but you like scary, right?
New longer-lasting juicy fruit. Sweet.
Dude. I wanted that.
Yeah? And?
Don't rest you for it.
Gotta have sweet. Gotta have longer lasting juicy fruit.
For 2006, Fast has a look all its own. The Grand Prix GXP is the only V8 engine in its class. And the 400 horsepower GTO is the most powerful car in its class. And now, each is priced to take out the competition. But don't take our word for it. Google Pontiac and discover for yourself the power of design.
Welcome back, Half-Lifers. Are you bored of cheating your way through the world yet? Me neither. Why does being bad just feel so good? Okay, this time we want you to use your jumping skills like David Lee Roth and master the use of your gravity gun like, that super famous gravity gun mastering guy?
You there! Stop where you are! Stay on the rocks! Don't step on the sand! It makes the antlions crazy!
You better listen to that guy. Help! These ferocious creatures will tear you apart. Your mission here is to cross antlion country to the Vortigaunt camp. You'll need some sweet platform jumping skills and your trusty gravity gun. The level starts off fairly easy with very makeable jumps. For longer distances, don't forget to use your gravity gun to bring in some debris and use those as stepping stones. When you've reached the protruding rocks, your jumping skills will be put to the test. Here, you'll need to use your sprint jump. Give yourself a little run-up space and go for it. Don't worry about landing on it. The flat rock behind it will give you ample landing room. Continue until you've reached the giant wooden seesaw. Carefully position yourself on one end and then use the gravity gun to pull a crate off the sand and place it next to you. Then, pull the crate from the other end and place it with the other crate. Voila! All those hours in physics class are finally paying off. The Vortigaunt camp is to the left. When you've reached the edge of the outcrop, you should see a barn to the left. The gap between outcrops is too far to jump across, so you'll need to find a wooden plank to bridge the distance. Once you're across, use that same plank and get yourself up to the deck. Refill on supplies in the boathouse if you need to. Use the plank again to bridge yourself to the White House with the red shingles. Turn on the generator behind the house to activate the thumper. With its rhythmic thumping, the sand is now safe to walk on, but only within close proximity of the machine. The antlions will keep their distance. So gravity gun some explosive barrels and blow up some bugs. Head over to the upper ledge and take out any remaining antlions. Make sure you load up on ammo before jumping down onto the sand. Only one more obstacle stands between you and the Vortigaunt camp, the antlion guard. When it appears, make your way to the far end of this area where you'll find a friendly resistance fighter on a gun turret. Don't get too close to the antlion guard. It'll use its head to cause blunt damages. Fire everything you've got, but stay close to the barricade so the friendlies can take down the smaller antlions. A couple of good shots with the explosive barrels and the shotgun should bring this beast down. Congratulations, you've made it to the Vortigaunt camp.
See, was that hard? Of course not. It never is when you cheat. And speaking of foul play, up next you'll learn to manipulate the game for codes with everything from level skipping to controlling the physics to entering God mode. I swear, you'll feel like one of the users from Tron.
Freeing the people of City 17 can be a hazardous occupation. Do you want to rampage through the combines with ease? Well, Freedom Fighter, I got the answer you're looking for. First, go to the Options menu and under the Keyboard tab, select the Advanced button. Then, check the box for Enable Developer Console. Now you're set to unleash hell on these alien invaders. Hit the tilde key to open up the developer console and type in s-v_cheats1. From here, you can enter in any of Half-Life 2's cheat codes. And let me just tell you, there's a ridiculous amount, so we'll just concentrate on the essentials. Let's just say for some reason you've lost all your saves and have to start the game all over again. Instead of starting from the beginning, hit the tilde key and enter the following cheat code to unlock all the chapters in the game. Now you can cruise to any level you want to continue your quest. Hey, it sure beats riding that train into City 17 again. What's that? You don't want to start at the beginning of a level? I have the answer right here. Hit the tilde key again and enter the following code. This will give you a listing of level points you can start at. Then enter map as the level code and voila, teleportation that works better than Dr. Kleiner's machine. You may be saying to yourself, skipping levels is nice and all, but I want to dish out some payback. Then the following code is for you. This will give you enough firepower to wipe that smug off that Metro cop. As an added bonus, you can bind it to any unused key. Just type in the following command and the cheat will activate every time that key is pressed. Don't worry, we haven't forgotten God mode. Open up the developer console again with the tilde key and type in God. Remember that hunter chopper that was chasing you in City 17? Say hello to my little friend. Now that you've mastered the art of the cheats, let's talk about how you can manipulate the physics. During any level, enter the following three commands. The tab key returns the physics to normal speed. Hitting Q will slow the physics down drastically, and pressing caps lock will freeze the object in midair. Now, whoever said physics was boring hasn't tried it in Half-Life 2.
Now, don't you worry if you didn't get all that, my cheating faithful. There's a whole semester's worth of crib notes on our Cheat Sheet Master Database. Just head on over to g4tv.com/cheat. There's even some codes we didn't show you just now. No, seriously, go ahead and look. I'm just gonna watch these commercials. I hope that one about the spicy burger's on, cause I sure is hungry.
Whoa, that was close.
I know.
Guys! What are you doing? You're playing video games when you could have a job creating them. With the right training, you could be an animator, a game analyst, or a game programmer. Make sure video games are a part of your future.
Train online for a career in game design. Call toll-free 877-558-2953. That's 877-558-2953. Call now.
Talking free pizza, people. Give me a hoo-ha two times Tuesday.
Hoo-ha.
That's what I'm talking about.
It's two times Tuesday at Domino's. Buy any large pizza at regular menu price. Get a second pizza of equal or lesser value free. Get the door. It's Domino's.
Heading back to school? Get the edge and go mobile with a Gateway convertible notebook. Take notes directly on screen with Microsoft Office OneNote pre-installed. Create flashcards and easily share them with classmates. An Intel dual-core processor gives you the power to do more while working in multiple applications. Order your convertible notebook today and customize it just the way you like it. Call 1-800-GATEWAY or visit gateway.com.
Wheels worth of cheesy goodness. That's snacking strong.
Tonight, on Attack of the Show, we're debating your favorite pastime, MySpace hookups in the loop. Plus, we'll talk with Jay and Silent Bob, plus Rosario Dawson, about the madness that is Clerks 2. It's Attack of the Show tonight at 7 p.m. Eastern.
Tonight on Midnight Spank, it's Brainiac, G4's extreme experiment lab.
Do you trust science?
They take the myths of science and bust them wide open.
I regret nothing!
It's Brainiac, part of Midnight Spank. Tonight at 12 midnight, only on G4.
Welcome back, my little nerdy ne'er-do-wells. We've come a long way, but we ain't out of the woods just yet. In Chapter 10, you'll encounter one of the fiercest firefights in Half-Life history. My inclination is to hide in the corner, but if you're a slightly bolder type, you can also use the following cheap tricks to blast your way out of the situation. Have fun. In the chapter Entanglement, you'll finally meet up with Alex again.
I'm glad you made it here in one piece. My dad's up there somewhere, in that holding area. It's gonna take some doing to get him out.
Fight off the Combine soldiers on your way to the interrogation room, where you'll find Eli trapped in some kind of cocoon.
Alex, Gordon!
After sending Eli to the teleport chamber, it's your mission to get yourself and Alex there. We'll tackle some of the stickier situations and make your trip a little bit easier.
Let's get out of here.
When you've reached the command security post, you'll have to fight off several waves of Combine soldiers. But this time, you have two sentry guns at your disposal. Place one overlooking each staircase and prepare for the assault. The Combine soldiers will be trying to knock down the sentry guns, and it's your job to keep them up and pointed over the staircase. The action here will be fast and result brutal. The Combines will stop coming when Alex shows up. You'll find out who Mossman has been working for and what's happening to Eli.
Damn her! I don't believe this!
Continue on your own, and eventually you'll come into a room filled with electrified water. Start by moving to the pipes over the railing. Then use your gravity gun to pull a blue barrel over to you and use it to distract the barnacle when jumping to the next platform. Move to the lower level and use the gravity gun to pull a couple of wooden crates. Shoot them over to the stairs, and you can use them as stepping stones to cross the water. Continue until you've reached cell block D8, which is lined with two giant cell block corridors and a security station between them. Alex will tell you to set up the sentry guns for the oncoming rush of attackers.
Quick, get these set up.
The placement of the three sentry guns is vital. Place them in the corridor without the balcony. This way, you won't be overwhelmed from above. Place one to cover each of the energy walls and one covering the far hallway. As soon as you place the last sentry gun, the Combines will be coming at you with everything they've got. Don't hide in a corner because your sentry guns can't do everything on their own. You'll need to provide fire support as well. If the sentry guns are knocked down, quickly reset them and make sure they're all aiming at the necessary areas. This frantic barrage will last for about 3 minutes until Alex arrives.
Sorry to take so long, Gordon. Looks like you could have used some help.
Recharge your health and your ammo before moving on with Alex.
Continue through the double doors where the Combine has a little surprise for you. Use your machine gun and a couple of grenades to clear out the room. Once it's cleared, follow Alex to the teleport chamber. Here, you'll finally find Mossman, and she tries to argue her innocence, but Alex ignores her.
Shut up and be glad you're still some use to us. We're going to reconfigure this teleport and get the hell out of here.
We won't spoil what happens next, but let's just say you're left to fend for your lives. Again. Set up the three sentry guns, each facing an energy wall around the teleport, and fight off the Combine until the teleport is ready to go.
So, that's it. We cheated and lied our way through another episode, and no one's the wiser. Like I always say, cheating's a victimless crime. Unless, of course, you count the scores of bad guys you gunned down with your unlimited ammo. Anyways, if you'd like us to take out the difficulty factor of your favorite game, visit the message boards at g4tv.com/cheat or send us an email at cheat@g4tv.com. You can also steal the codes from today's show at the Cheat Sheet Master Database. Until next time, I'm Kristin Holt, and I'm a cheater.
Hey, eyes on your own paper. Wait, what am I saying? Next on Cheat, we'll be stealing the answer key to Konami's Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. Don't worry, they say it tastes like chicken. Welcome to Cheat. I'm Kristin Holt. This episode's all about the appetizingly named Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. First up, we sit down with game creator Hideo Kojima. As the game guru behind the MGS series, Kojima's credited with making stealth games popular. Of course, we didn't have any trouble finding him. You know what they say, it takes a thief to catch a thief.
After the end of World War II, the world was split into two, East and West. This marked the beginning of the era called the Cold War.
Metal Gear Solid 3, Snake Eater, is actually a prequel to the other Metal Gear games. So if you played those, you literally have to play this one to keep from messing up the whole space-time continuum thing. And you don't want to mess that up, do you? Didn't think so. Anyway, in MGS 3, you're tasked with recovering the Shagahat, and you gotta get past the Gru Armada, plus your former mentor and pal, the Boss, to accomplish your mission.
Boss?
Confused? Well, just demolish something. That usually helps.
I consider MGS to be the 007 series. We're a totally different group of people keep on producing these films. We finally felt like it was coming together, even though it was the third one, and we were able to do what we wanted to do.
One of your best buds in the latest installment of this groundbreaking game is Major Tom. He'll be contacting you on the radio.
This will be a sneaking mission. You must not be seen by the enemy. You must leave no trace of your presence. Is that clear? This kind of infiltration is the Fox unit's speciality. In other words, weapons and equipment are procured on site. That goes for food as well.
I have to find my own weapons and equipment? Whose crazy idea was this anyway?
After you've been out in the field for a while, your stamina will start to drop. To recover lost stamina, you can hunt for local flora and fauna.
In the game, I love instant noodles. And even in real life, I like instant noodles.
The food of the future. A well-balanced meal for the space age.
But I guess, in real life, I'm a sushi fan.
Sushi?
It's Japanese. I hear it's all the rage right now. Supposedly, it's made from raw fish.
For most of his missions, Snake's on his own when it comes to acquiring guns and ammo. Luckily, Snake knows a thing or two about close-quarters combat.
What was that? Some kind of judo?
No, it's called CQC, a basic form of close quarters combat.
And can take down his foes hand to hand. Snake can use CQC to take down his enemies without alerting others to his location. Or he can interrogate them for vital information.
Radio 144.86.
To me, MGS has come to an end with this trilogy. I plan to work on new projects, things I haven't done before. There are younger groups of people, and I would like for them to pick up from where I left off, so they can come out with more MGS games. So I don't think the MGS series will come to an end.
Snake Eater. 3, 2, 1,
Spread your wings and fly. God be with you.
Next up, you'll learn where to find a really cool crocodile hat disguise in the second mission. One important safety note, though. It works much better in the jungle than it does, say, on the bus or at the mall, just so you know. You'll also learn to lay a beating on your old buddy Ocelot. Damn, doesn't that guy ever get tired of beatings?
Viewer Matt C. has written in to ask for the location of the crocodile cap, a very useful piece of camouflage. Okay, Matt, we'll help you find the lid. Start heading southwest until you encounter a submerged log. Dive under the log and head for the opposite shore. Once you land, collect anything you find, then head east until you come to this tree. Scurry up the tree, then jump down to the vines below. Crawl across to the next set of vines and drop down. Hey, what's this? Why, it's a perfectly good crocodile cap. Use it to sneak up on some enemy soldiers. One important safety note. While the croc cap may fool humans, other crocodiles seem to get real pissed off when they find you wearing their buddy on your head. Crocodiles are sensitive like that.
It's just you and me. No one to get in our way.
The Bolsaya is also the location for your first boss battle against Ocelot. Now, Ocelot has a cool name and some impressive pistolero flourishes, but he's basically a punk ass.
12 shots.
His main fighting technique is to duck behind a rock or a tree to tempt you into wasting your bullets. Don't fall for it. Instead, duck behind your own rock and wait until you get a clean shot. Or you can shoot down the beehives over Ocelot's head to flush him out of hiding. If you run out of bullets or grenades, there's more behind the trees to the east. So remember, to take the showboating Ocelot down a notch, make like Muhammad Ali. Float like a butterfly and sting like a bee.
Damn it. Found us.
We have to take a break, but later on we've got boss battles and a bunch of Easter eggs involving Japanese pop stars. I'll explain when we get back.
Brought to you by Toyota. Choose any direction as long as it's forward. Toyota, moving forward.
Everyone talks about how long their truck will last. When we build a truck, we think way down the road. Toyota Tundra has been factory tested to survive years of abuse. That's why day in, day out, through the worst of the elements, and all the rigors of time, nothing stops a Tundra. Toyota, moving forward. Special financing and lease options available now.
Go big. Go fast. Go Sonic Riders. Intense air action. Insane multiplayer battles. It's a pure adrenaline rush. Who needs wheels when you've got air? Sonic Riders. In stores now. Try to keep up. Rated E for everyone.
Jinx, clothing and gear for gamers, geeks, and hackers. Check it out at jinx.com.
Welcome back to Cheat and our look at Metal Gear Solid 3, Snake Eater. Did you ever notice how attractive women always travel in groups? In this next segment, I'll introduce you to some hot Japanese pop stars. They're hiding all over the place in this game. Oh, and when you meet them, play it cool.
Eva's a spy who isn't afraid to use all her natural attributes.
Thank you, Snake.
That's my girl. When you first meet her at the Rasvet compound, hit the R1 button to see if Snake's really got his mind on covert warfare. Then, if that's not enough, hit the R1 button again right after Snake wakes up from his nap to reveal Eva's other hidden talents.
What's this? A transmitter? Who's responsible for this?
Want to see more of the lovely Eva? After the torture cutscene, leave the transmitter chip in his back. When you rendezvous with Eva at the waterfall, you'll see a hidden cutscene.
There's something in here. It's so hard.
Oh. When did it get like that?
Hold still. Let me do it. Ah! There, a transmitter.
Hideo Kojima has hidden other sexy Easter eggs in Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. In the Gorky Labs, posters of Japanese pop idols can be found all over the place. Here's one of Mariko Okubo in all her glory. And look at the wall of this prison cell. A poster of Mary Shimamura is hiding a tunnel that some industrious con dug with his rock hammer. But one of the best hidden posters in the game can be found during the cutscene in the drone plane. Wait for the R1 icon to appear and press up on the analog stick to find a beautiful stowaway accompanying you on your next mission. How romantic. Not only are there fun posters in the game, but gaming magazines can be found here too. Just shoot the cover and the magazines will pop open. All these magazines have Metal Gear Solid covers on them, all except for one. Here, Metal Gear pays tribute to Hugh Hefner and his own brand of bunnies. But not all Easter eggs can be easily found. When Snake gets captured, throw back the food the guard tosses into the cell 3 times. This will activate a funny cutscene where Snake will say anything to get out.
You must be pretty lonely.
Yeah, I am pretty lonely. Really lonely. Hey, don't you go getting any funny ideas.
The cutscene will also reveal another way to get out if Snake's proposition doesn't work. When the guard starts talking about his family,
my dad's a Johnny, and my son's son will probably be a Johnny too.
Look at the back of the photo he holds up. It's the radio frequency to open the jail cell.
The whole clan of Johnnies.
If you thought being in jail with Johnny was scary, wait till you meet a man named The Fear. Ooh, are you scared? Of course you are. You're cheating.
The Fear, as you might expect, is freaking scary. He's also probably the most active member of the Cobra unit you'll have to face in the game.
The boss's apprentice. I will give you fear such as you've never experienced before. Come into my web.
We recently received a distress signal from viewer Steve10390, who says he's having some trouble conquering his fears. Before confronting this Peter Parker wannabe, enter the cure menu and heal yourself. Remove the poison from your body, and while you're at it, take that pesky arrow out of your thigh. It might attract hipster piercing chicks, but it's no good for fighting. Next, turn on your thermal goggles to help you track the fear's movements in the trees. As a bonus, the crosshair from the goggles will give you an accurate weapons lock. The Fear may look menacing, but like most bullies, his bark is worse than his bite. His favorite thing to do is leap from tree to tree like George of the Jungle. Eventually, he'll wear himself out, then you can blast him. The key to beating the Fear is to keep a safe distance and follow him with your goggles, and shoot him when you have a clear shot. When the Fear does come down from the trees, he'll try to knock you down. But just resume your strategy of tracking and blasting, and you'll eventually defeat this king of the jungle.
I'm getting hungry. The Fear! The Fear!
After the break, that kooky Kojima will lead you on a very special Easter egg hunt. I suggest you put on your bunny costumes now. Seriously, hop along.
Let's count sand. It's not. Let's wait in line. Awesome. Where are all the good games? You guys have nothing. Zip. Nada.
We have nada. 3. With Gamefly, you can rent games from home. Choose from virtually every console game available, and we'll deliver them right to your door. There are no late fees, and shipping is always free. Programs start at only $14.95 a month. Go to Gamefly.com today to try Gamefly for free. Rated E through M.
Right now, a high-performance Dell XPS system with an Intel Pentium D processor with dual-core processing and a 17-inch ultra-sharp flat panel can be yours for only $9.99. And for a limited time, qualified XPS customers pay no interest for 12 months. XPS, the ultimate Dell PC.
Go big. Go fast. Go Sonic Riders. Intense air action, insane multiplayer battles. It's a pure adrenaline rush. Who needs wheels? when you've got air. Sonic Riders. In stores now. Try to keep up. Rated E for everyone.
Have you ever talked to a woman without having to give your credit card number?
Triumph, the Insult Comic Dog. Sunday night at 11, only on G4.
Welcome back to Cheat. You know, for me, Easter's never been about biting the heads off those cute little bunnies. But you know what I do like? Easter eggs. We talked to Hideo Kojima about his favorite secrets in the game.
In the game, right after you're captured.
It's no use. He's not going to talk. He's been trained not to break. Trained by me.
Go ahead and save your game in a different profile. Leave the game, and then come back and load up that save file from the cell area. What Snake is seeing is a nightmare from his dreams. The nightmare game you're playing was created by the Zoe 2 team. They've worked on this game for quite some time. Originally, what I wanted to do was have this nightmare sequence be that side-scrolling shooter nemesis. You know, Gradius. You'll get to play that game, and if you get to the end, then you'll be able to wake up. But it was too straightforward, throwing in a game you already knew. So we changed it. You'll be able to play this game that has nothing to do with Metal Gear Solid. And after a few minutes, you'll return to your normal gameplay, where you wake up from the nightmare. So it'll be interesting and shocking for players.
There's this thing in the game, when you're at the Mangrove River, right after you battle the Pain. You'll head towards the end of the river, and there'll be a demo where the end appears.
The old man is always sleeping. Is he all right?
The end is saving what life he has left in him for battle. Normally, he's dead. But he'll wake up when the time is right.
Right after the demo ends, you can use the sniper rifle in like 3 or 4 seconds and kill the end. If you're successful and you get to the forest area, where you have to battle him, he won't be there because he'll be dead. So it's a totally different story because you won't have to experience that boss battle. Instead, you'll be fighting the ocelots, the guys in the red caps.
Another thing, there are mouse traps in the game. If you place a mouse trap in certain areas of the game, you'll be able to capture this Uma, an unidentified, mysterious animal. It's this legendary creature you can capture within the game.
So where does this elusive Uma hang out? Well, that's for us to know and you to find out. Come on, cheaters, we can't tell you everything. However, if you do find this secretive little scamp, drop us a line at our website, g4tv.com/cheat. There's nothing wrong with tooting your own horn a little bit. Remember, if you want to see the nightmare Easter egg we just described, you have to save the game, stop playing, and reload the level. That's right, I said it, stop playing. So have you learned enough dirty tricks yet? Didn't think so. That's why we're also going to slip you the keys to some of the game's unlockables. Who says crime doesn't pay? Like any good Special Forces operative, Snake is a master of improvised camouflage. Most camouflages can be found just lying around, while others are obtained by defeating the Cobra Elites with just your tranquilizer gun. Hey. Unlock the following 2 special disguises once you finish the game and watch old Snakey's face light up. Throughout the game, you'll notice some little frogs called curation that make annoying sounds when you hit them. Well, what would you do if someone hit you? There's 1 frog for each area in the game. Collect them all and you'll unlock the Stealth Camo, a designer original that will give you the best coverage in any surroundings. There's another super suit to be unlocked in the Snake vs. Monkey minigame. The first 3 levels are unlocked from the beginning, but the last 2 can only be unlocked once you finish the game. You may notice that these are the same monkeys that made Spike so mad in Ape Escape 2. Hey, that's not nice. If you can sucker punch these simians in record time on each level, you'll unlock the monkey mask and banana camo. Konami made the first level of this minigame the hardest. Trying to capture 9 of these little monkeys in just under a minute is as tough as it gets. Fortunately, we've got the strategy laced for you.
2, 1, start!
Your first target is the monkey hiding in the grass south of the cliffs. Once you bag his banana chomping ass, take aim at the 2 on the left. Be sure to keep your distance from the first one or he'll scurry away and ruin everything. With those 2 nabbed, hop over the log and tranquilize the little guy who's just hanging out.
Jump back over the log and stay on the inside part of the trees to save a few precious seconds. You should soon see another monkey ambling down a hill. When he gets close enough, monkey nap him.
Gotcha.
When you reach the top, you'll find another monkey just kind of lounging around. Nab him, then quickly look up and shoot the next monkey high atop this tree. After that, drop down, look to the left, and snag the next monkey before he gets away. Once you bag him, there's just one more. He's walking on the limbs of this tree. Now you're finished.
All done.
Of course, you also smell of monkey.
You know how hard it is to get that monkey smell out of your clothes? Anyway, right after the break, we'll totally spoil the ending of the game for you. As giddy as a schoolgirl.
Good night, Neil. Why so blue, Panda Bear?
Whatever.
You are a buffet of manliness. Milky Way, comfort in every bar.
Are you still being charged too much for internet service? Still waiting for a better deal? Well, your wait is over. With People PC Online, you get unlimited internet access for just $10.95 a month. And you get accelerator technology free for an entire year. That's a $60 value. Visit up to 5 web pages in the time it used to take to visit one. And pay just $10.95 a month. Plus, our smart dialer automatically chooses the fastest, most reliable access number. Want more? You even get security tools to help protect you from spam, pop-ups, and email viruses. Compare us side-by-side with your current ISP. Go to peoplepc.com to try us free for 30 days. Surf up to 5 times faster for an entire year with free accelerator technology. All this for just $10.95 a month. But hurry, this special offer is for a limited time only. Go online or call 1-800-537-2017. People PC Online with free accelerator, a better way to internet.
New G.I. Joe Sigma 6 is here. Cobra Commander, Snake Eyes, Long Range, Ninja Bat, Kamakura, Cobra Ninja Bat's attack. Can Kamakura send him to the scrap heap? You're in command. G.I. Joe Sigma 6, figure sold separately.
Welcome to Cheat, the show where you're only cheating yourself and the thousands of enemy soldiers you blow away. This time, we're going to take a look at some cool tributes to other Konami games hidden in Metal Gear Solid 3. We'll also hook you up with the password for the new PSP game, Metal Gear Acid. Man, we are totally spoiling you!
Confused? Yeah, well, you should be. This handsome fellow, Raiden, from Metal Gear Solid 2, shouldn't be around yet. However, if you grew attached to Raiden during hours of furious gameplay, you can select his face by choosing I Like MG2 from the main menu. When you start a new game, you can see the changes in Jack's appearance from the opening cutscene.
Does this pantywaist know what he's doing?
If you still can't get enough of Raiden, and who can, don't worry, this isn't his only cameo. We think Colonel Rykov from the weapons lab looks suspiciously familiar, don't you? You can also find a poster of your favorite future Metal Gear inside the locker where Colonel Rykov's body is stashed later on. References to other Konami games can be found in the upper levels of the Gorky Labs. There are two paintings in this library that also hang in the final stage of Silent Hill 3. Creepy, right? There are also two special codes that have been hidden within the game that'll bring a smile to every gamer's pale, sun-starved face. When you first enter the Gorky Labs, head for the soldier in the main lobby. He'll be the only one standing there looking all soldiery. Interrogating him will uncover a special secret.
Acid password, J-E-H-U-T-Y.
Jehuti, of course, is not only a super neat password, but it's also a reference to Konami's new game, Metal Gear Acid, coming out for the PSP. Another cheat code comes from an unlikely source, your ally Eva. While the two of you are walking in the woods, grab her suddenly and interrogate her for some surprising information.
Left, right, left, right. I don't remember the rest.
But we do. It's an homage to the first set of cheat codes implemented into a Konami video game, Contra, for the NES. Now that's old school.
Stop shooting me.
In the final battle of the game, you'll be lacing up your gloves and facing one badass chick. I have to warn you. To beat her, you may have to fight dirty. You don't have a problem with that, do you?
I'll give you 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, MiGs will come and bomb the hell out of this place. If you can beat me in less than 10 minutes, you'll be able to escape in time.
This is it. The fourth quarter, sudden death. Two enter, one leaves. You got 10 minutes to defeat the person who made you the big, bad soldier you are today. We've got a request from viewer Big Sounda, who's having trouble with the boss in the final mission.
Nice try.
To prepare for battle, equip any camouflages that'll help you blend into the surroundings. Next, select your survival knife to help combat the boss's CQC attacks. When she grabs you, try to break her grip and knock her down. Oh, and when she's on the ground, aim for her head with your AK-47. Run a little ways off and let her chase you. When she tries to shoot you with her Patriot, get in front and you can outrun it.
Let's see what you're made of.
Although it's good exercise, it won't work every time. But you should be able to win about 75% of the time, and this will give you the upper hand on the legendary boss. When you do get knocked down, remember to use the cure menu to mend your broken bones or your health will start to deplete. When you do exert too much energy fighting the boss, run and hide behind some trees or take cover in the bushes. Once you recover enough health, continue with your hand-to-hand combat and eventually you'll slay the big bad boss bitch.
Jack. Or should I say, Snake. You're a wonderful man. Kill me. Kill me now. Do it. There's only room for one boss and one snake.
Snake eater! Okay, kids, that's it. Another illicit tryst comes to an end. I trust I'll be seeing you at the after party, but if we don't run into each other, leave me a message on the boards at g4tv.com/cheat or email me at cheat@g4tv.com. As always, you can find the codes from today's show on the Cheat Sheet Master Database. So until next time, I'm Kristin Holt, and it's been a pleasure cheating with you.
Attention, G4 viewers! Stop humping your Lara Croft dolls! Triumph is here!
So tell us about your new sitcom that's going to be off the air in 2 months.
Have you ever talked to a woman without having to give your credit card number?
How can something so tiny and delicate be such a filthy and brutal whore?
The best of Triumph the Insult Comic Dog. Sunday night at 11, only on G4.
Feel free to invite your imaginary girl.
Zombies. They shuffle, they moan, they eat brain. They're just straight up annoying. Are you tough enough to tackle the zombie problem in Resident Evil 4? If you are, stick around because we need to talk. Hola, ¿qué pasó? Ahora, muérete en el punto de mi horca. That's Spanish for, hey, what's up? Now, die at the end of my pitchfork. It's a handy phrase to know when you encounter the Spanish-speaking, zombie-esque villagers who roam around Resident Evil 4. Welcome to Cheat. I'm Kristin Holt, and today we'll give you the guided tour of the latest thriller from Capcom. And they say you can't learn by cheating, fools. The bright minds at Capcom have taken the franchise in a bold new direction with Resident Evil 4. It's been 6 years since Raccoon City. The Umbrella Corporation is gone, and ghastly zombie hordes no longer roam the land. In fact, it's getting downright pleasant on good old Earth. This time around, Leon Kennedy, the rookie cop from Resident Evil 2, is back, and now he's on a mission to find Ashley, the president's daughter.
I'll go on. I'm counting on you guys.
Yeah, we'll stay and watch the car.
With Umbrella destroyed, there are no zombies this time. But don't be sad. Buck up, kid. There are plenty of extremely zombie-ish infected villagers for you to bash. In fact, this so-called little village seems to have had a population larger than Dallas, Texas. And what's worse, these semi-dead farmhands are even trickier and more powerful than their predecessors. But if you still want more monsters to mash, no sweat. You'll also come face to hideous face with some of the best bosses we've ever seen. And your dexterity and quick thinking will be put to the test.
you don't want to become someone else's tasty snack. The story isn't the only new and improved feature. The static, neck-ache-inducing camera angles are gone, and now you see things in a new light. A nifty, over-the-shoulder, third-person view gets you up close and personal with all your ugly foes. Luckily, if you get too close, you can hit B and down on the stick to pull a 180. Hey, he who fights and runs away, right? Another new ability is shooting people anywhere on their body. This revamped mechanic makes body part-specific targeting not only fun, but strategically advantageous. It's no longer how much you shoot someone, it's where. And you've also got new Void Rage roundhouses and knife attacks for when you're out of ammo. Upgrading weapons is one of the best parts of this game. Throughout, you'll encounter a merchant from whom you can find the latest in ass-kickery. Nope, he doesn't take any crap, and he doesn't take American Express. You need a lot of pesetas to deal with spooky, sensitive salesman guy, so save up. Watch out, though. He's sensitive. If you shoot his face off or something, he'll leave you. Our favorite thing is weapons upgrades. You can juice up four facets of your pea shooter: firepower, speed, reload, and capacity. Be sure to upgrade your attaché case ASAP. Case space quickly becomes prime real estate in this game. More space-saving advice? Mix herbs whenever you can to save room, and use the L and R triggers to rotate items. When you leave the weapons recovery screen, anything in the secondary space will be gone like your girlfriend after you play this game for 93 hours straight. So don't delete it unless you mean it.
Thank you.
But our absolute favorite thing about this version versus the others is that typewriter ribbons are out. Like, well, typewriter ribbons. Typewriters still function as save spots, but you're no longer restricted by the number of ribbons you have, but by the space on your memory card. Now save as much as you want. Anyway, now you've got all the info you need, so get out there and save Ashley. Your commander-in-chief is counting on you.
Came here looking for this girl.
Ashley, girl, what's up with the kidnappings? Are you hanging out with Robin the Boy Wonder? For the last time, if the zombie overlord offers you candy, don't get in the car, jeez. We'll be back in a few minutes. Welcome back to Cheat. I'm Kristin Holt, the chick you're cheating with, and today we're pulling a fast one on the zombie-ish hordes of Resident Evil 4. While we were gone, Leon got himself in trouble again, big surprise, and he needs your help. In this level, you have to choose between two battles. Lucky for you, we obtained some insider intel on each. On this level, you're barricaded in a cabin while bloodthirsty Europeans try to kill you.
Quick, in that cabin!
Sounds like a typical trip to France.
Okay, it's game time.
The first thing to do is rearrange furniture. Block as many windows as you can with bookcases to buy time. Then, hunker down by the staircase, equip your shotgun, and brace yourself for the onslaught. If you're worried about your boy Luis, that's nice, but don't. He can handle himself. When you get overwhelmed by the European stinky cheese breath, head upstairs and break out the TMP. Just when the battle starts getting too hot, the zombos will decide to retreat.
Looks like they're backing off.
When you get down to the crossroads, you have a choice to make. The left fork leads to the Chainsaw Sisters, the right to El Gigante. I know, it sounds like a lose-lose, but don't you worry. We've got the intel to cheat your way out. Choose the left gate and you'll be fighting in a mine. And what's the golden rule of mine fighting? Don't drag the president's daughter around while you do it. Instead, stash Ashley in a container as soon as you can. She'll stay out of trouble and let you focus on some serious villager pillaging. When you've battled your way to the pit, the Chainsaw Sisters will make their grand debut. Unless you're curious about getting chainsawed, climb the ladder and head back to the entrance. The fighting's easier when you can funnel your enemies to one spot. Equip your shotgun for maximum blastage. If you run out of shells, use incendiary or regular grenades to finish the job. Once the sisters are in smithereens, pick up the ruby and camp key from their corpses. Oh, and wipe them off before you stow them. Now let's reverse the curse for a sec and look at the right gate. This leads to the lair of El Gigante, who's just a big old meanie. I find that dropping a boulder on him is a great way to say, hey, lighten up, guy. After that, shoot the locks off the gate and grab the old key from shack number 2. Before you reach the second wall, you'll find another boulder you can drop on Señor Gigante to slow him down. Shoot the locks on the next gate and move through. Annoyingly, on this level, you can't stash Ashley, so be careful. Make sure she gets first aid and a crash course in ogre avoidance, because if she dies, it's game over. Blast the monster with your shotgun and TMP. When the parasite sprouts on its back, slice it off. Repeat this twice more, and ding dong, the Wicked Witch is dead.
Wow, I haven't seen that many ugly guys since I worked as a lumberjack in college. What? I did. Next up, we'll pander to you, the cherished viewers, by answering your questions about the big bad boss man village chief. You're welcome.
Like school, some people will blow through this game and others will need help. Welcome to the wonderful world of cheating.
Hasta luego.
Next to join our merry band are Minipan and Camanthea, who want the answers to Mr. Village Chief's deadly pop quiz. No worries, guys. Vitores Mendez, aka Village Chief, his weak spot is his spine. This important body part is best targeted with the shotgun or the TMP. You can also get hot for teacher by blowing up barrels. Sorry to say it, guys, but merely cheating isn't enough this time. Vitores has devastating lunge attacks that you'll have to dodge. Although this is one tough boss man, he does tip his hand before striking. Watch his nasty buggy arms. They flinch just before he attacks. It's not much, but it might keep you breathing. Keep hammering Big Ugly's spine, and he'll eventually split in half. But it's not over yet. Like a good horror monster, the Torres will now start swinging around the crossbeams like a bloody half-monkey, half-zombie guy thing. Scurry up the ladder and collect the herbs from the windows. Keep the high ground and blast half-Village Chief when it gets too close. Continue busting caps in him and he'll be dead in no time. After all, his second attack was pretty half-ass in the first place.
After that, I need a break. But when we come back, the next boss battle we're breaking down is one of the hardest we've ever seen. Welcome back to Cheat. With my help, you've ducked and duped your way through half of Resident Evil 4. But don't go patting yourself on the back just yet. You'll need both hands on the controller when you face the next matching set of Big Uglies. Stick and move, baby, stick and move.
Ready for another lesson in Espanol? Okay, repeat after me. Los dos gigantes. That means the two giants. And you're gonna have to get past both of them if you want to survive Chapter 4-2. Start by entering the mine and take out the villagers blocking your way. Head for the platform overlooking the facility, draw your rifle, and snipe miners like it was the last day of miner sniping season. Then, jump to the lower level and finish them off CQB style. When you move on, you'll find a boulder blocking the way. Luckily, this mine has extremely shabby dynamite security policies. Pull the lever near the boulder, and you'll summon a trolley. Well, sort of. To get the trolley all the way down, you'll need to head to the upper level to flip a circuit breaker. When you do, retrieve the dynamite and break that rock like you were on a chain gang. Next, proceed to the blast furnace. Here you will encounter two very unfriendly gigantes who want to kick your culo. Are you going to take that? Now each of these guys carries a bounty of 15,000 pesetas. But if you want to collect, you'll have to kill them the old-fashioned way. If you're not all about the Benjamin, un gigante is real easy to kill. Climb the scaffolding and wait for him to come over. Before he can swat you like a fly, use the winch to zip across the area. When you land, pull this lever and it's adios, amigo, one less gigante to worry about. Of course, you'll still have to deal with his friend, so... Use a flash grenade to stun the big fella, then blast him with your shotgun. Or, if you like, climb the scaffolding, lure him over, then zip line across and shoot him from a distance. This is a pattern he'll let you repeat over and over in true obliging video game monster fashion. You lure, he lumbers, you zip, you shoot him. It's a symbiotic relationship, really. There are ammunition and health recovery items scattered across the map, so pick them up as needed. Pepper El Gigante until the parasite appears. When it does, run over and slice it off. Once you've done enough damage, the monster will say no más.
That gigante can stand to lose a few pounds. Thankfully, on the next level, you can burn off lots of calories by dodging security beams. I think it could unseat Pilates as the next big exercise craze. seriously.
In Chapter 5-3, the ever-kidnappable Ashley has been, well, you guessed it, kidnapped by Sadler.
Come to me, Ashley.
And while you'll be tempted to just write her off, if you want to win the game, you've got to save her.
It's already begun.
Take out a couple baddies, and you'll see a cutscene with Krauser. But watch out. Keep your hands on the controller. This isn't some Kojima mega cutscene where you can polish off an order of hot wings. You'll need to be on your toes. After the cutscene, explore the throne room. Be careful, because security's tighter than next year's Source Awards. When three beams appear, run through when the horizontal beam's rising and the others are spreading. The next set is harder to pass. Wait until two beams form a triangle, then dart through. Watch out for the rising horizontal beam. Dodge the next two sets of beams and you're almost there. As you wait for the door to unlock, security will take one more crack at you. Bob and weave just as the beams arrive. At this point, you'll be totally sick of beams. So go down the elevator and enter Sadler's abode. Here, you'll meet It, aka U3. This guy's uglier than the whole cast of Alien vs. Predator. Arm your shotgun and shoot the green lights to open the control panel. You have 30 seconds to move to the next rig before it goes all Titanic on you. Continue to do this with the next two rigs while dodging attacks. When the third rig goes down, so will It. Bye-bye, It. See you soon. Sooner, it turns out, than you would have liked. Don't you hate it when monsters get multiple lives? You three will climb out of the bottomless pit. I guess it wasn't really all that bottomless, was it? And you'll have to start killing them all over again. The monster can be trapped temporarily behind the gate, where you can really unload on him. Blow up the explosive barrels to damage him even more. Continue this until he burrows into the ground. Now get ready for some serious duck and cover. Once it attacks, you'll have only seconds to unload whatever ordnance you have left into it. It's a tough battle, but the 50,000 pesetas you get when you win makes it all worthwhile. Go ahead, buy yourself something nice. Fight over to the fortress ruins and you'll face Krauser again. When the squabble begins, jet to the left room, grab all the tasty bonus items, and climb up the ladder. Hang out and attack Krauser with your shotgun and knife when he gets close. The first part of this battle's pretty quick. Head slowly through the gate and watch out for Krauser's ambush. The fight here will center on a series of button presses. Stay alert and he'll soon flash grenade away. Like a pesky little brother, Krauser will keep coming back for more. But unlike your little brother, it's okay to stab Krauser and shoot him with a shotgun. Fight him off long enough to grab two pieces of the holy beast, and the final battle will begin.
Two down, one more to go, Krauser.
My weapon of choice here is the Killer 7. Use it to blast K-Man's exposed legs, then unload on him when he's vulnerable. Stay alert, dodge his attacks, and eventually he'll go down. Now, go grab a Haunted Village flavor sports drink. You earned it.
Okay, good workout, gang. Now, I need a quick break here since Krauser really tested my reflexes. When we come back, I'll give you a sneak peek at the end of the game, and you'll learn to save Ashley. Again. See you soon. Welcome back to Cheat, the show that never actually admitted taking steroids, unlike some cheaters in the real world. We're still making our way through Resident Evil 4, and now I'm gonna suck all the enjoyment out of the game for you like some kind of enjoyment-sucking alien. This is your official spoiler warning. If you don't want to see how the game ends, go ahead and just borrow your dad's car for a quick two-minute joyride. I'm sure he won't mind.
Something's not right. Ashley, you stay here.
Okay, so you've clawed your way to the top. So what's your reward? How about a heaping helping of whoop-ass from Sadler, the ugliest boss we've seen since we worked the night shift at Waffle House?
Better try a new trick, because that one's getting old.
As is so often the case, Sadler's ugly inside and out. Unless, of course, you find weird leg eyes attractive. Not only are the eyes on Sadler's getaway sticks horrifying, they're also his weak point. Remember how your mom wouldn't buy you a BB gun because she said you shoot your eye out, blah, blah, blah? Well, that's the name of the game in this boss battle. Shooting out the S-Man's leg eyes will bring him down so you can target his main peeper. And don't be shy about using items from the environment either. Shooting out barrels and unloading cranes on his head will add extra damage. Just as you start getting tired of this battle, your good pal Ada will arrive with the rocket launcher.
Use this!
Ada, it's just what I wanted! How did you know? Now you just need to cross the collapsible bridge to get it. But keep your thumbs on the dodge button. There's a reason they call this bridge collapsible. Pick up the rocket launcher and target Sadler's main eye. Once Sadler's toast, you have 180 little seconds to get Ashley off the island.
Yeah. We have to get off this island now. It's gonna blow any minute.
It's gonna what?
Luckily, that thoughtful Ada has left a Sea-Doo for you. Take it and skidoo. Put the pedal to the metal and watch out for falling rocks, and it'll soon be smooth sailing. Now, what would an RE game be without a cheesetastic ending? Nothing, that's what. Good thing, then, that the guys outdid themselves with this.
So, after you take me back to my place, how about we do some, overtime?
Ouch. That ending's cheesier than a zodiac sign medallion and fish tank shoes. The bright side of that cheesy moment is that you can buy the infinite rocket launcher you've always wanted. Hopefully you've got the million pesetas to foot the bill. Now, what would an episode of Cheat be if we didn't show you how to pick the locks to a bonus level? Pencils at the ready, people. It's cheating time.
So, you've beaten the game. Now what? Well, it's time to head for the famous Resident Evil after party. In Assignment Ada, you play as the lovely Miss Wong, and you need to collect 5 Plagueis samples.
He knows.
Work your way to the Gatling Gunner, cross back over the gap, then drop your enemies into the water. Now you can focus on the guy with the big gun and the bad attitude. From your position across the divide, you can put him down with your sniper rifle, then pick up the ammo and health items. Now, blast your way to the air duct. It's the large duct-shaped opening with all the air. Okay, good. Inside, check the map for the Plagueis sample locations. Sample 1 is in the research lab. Take out the guards and retrieve it. Sample 2 is easy to get, but exiting the lab is a different story. Soldiers are now converging on you, and they all want you to shoot them. Oblige them for a spell until the big guy gets close. Then, shoot the explosive tank and run like hell. This door is your next checkpoint. Now you'll discover that some do-gooder has locked the room. You need to operate the panel to unlock it. Of course, as you do, an army of soldiers will storm in. Instead of killing everyone, just carve a bloody swath through them and take off. Get the 3rd plasma sample by clearing out this room. You could bust in guns blazing, but it's easier to shoot everyone through the door. You know, much less splatter on your clothing and all. As you're searching for the 4th sample, you'll be ambushed by another Gatling gunner. Is there a Gatling gunner school around here or something? Duck under the stairs, use your grenades on the henchmen, then use the TMP to take them out. Now you're almost done. Clear out the lab and grab the 4th sample. Don't forget to stock up on ammo and herb. Healing herb, that is. The fight with Krauser is a test of your reflexes. This is where all those thumb push-ups pay off. Use your TMP to force him back, then blast at his legs to expose his upper body. When he's all nice and vulnerable, let him have it with both barrels. Eventually, you'll wear him down. Not in the mood to fight fair? Me either. Forget that. Here's a quick trick. Retrace your steps and exit the battle area. Now, equip your sniper rifle and shoot Krauser from a nice, safe distance. If you do this enough, he'll drop a ninja vanishing smoke bomb thing and break out. Now, the Plagueis sample's yours for the taking. Once you beat this mini-mission like the red-headed stepchild that it is, the Tommy gun will be available from the merchant for 1,000,000 pesetas. We know it's expensive, but once you have a Tommy gun, you can talk like a gangster and say stuff like, "You'll never take me alive, copper, see?" And you can't put a price on that.
Well, that's it. Once again, we did the dirty deed and went undetected. Just how I like it. If you haven't been taking notes, and why haven't you? You can look up anything you missed from today's show on the Cheat Sheet Master Database at g4tv.com/cheat. Also, if you have a problem, and if you can find them, you can leave a message for the Cheat team on the message boards or email me at cheat@g4tv.com. Until next time, I'm Kristin Holt, and it's been a pleasure cheating with you.
Attention, G4 viewers. Stop humping your Lara Croft dolls. Triumph is here!
So tell us about your new sitcom that's going to be off the air in 2 months.
Have you ever talked to a woman without having to give your credit card number?
How can something so tiny and delicate be such a filthy and brutal whore?
The Best of Triumph, the Insult Comic Dog. Sunday night at 11, only on G4.
Feel free to invite your imaginary girl.
Psst, I got a mission for you. It's Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, and it's a matter of national security. Meet me back here in 20 seconds. The password is cheat. Welcome to today's show. But enough greeting, let's start cheating. I'm Kristin Holt, and today I'll be guiding you through Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. In the latest version of the game, Sam Fisher's back in black, covertly operating for the NSA's super secret third echelon. What happened to the other two echelons? Well, that information is strictly need to know, and you, my friend, do not need to know. No. You do, however, need to know this. In Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, workaholic secret agent Sam Fisher is brushing off his night vision goggles once again to protect our freedom.
When we started with Chaos Theory, we evaluate what were the core values of the brand, and we've been working very hard on these. We wanted to make the game more accessible for a larger audience so they could have more freedom on what they're doing.
And isn't freedom what it's all about? True to form, this title has a classic Tom Clancy storyline with plenty of intrigue. In essence, it's 2007, and the Japanese have created something called the Information Self-Defense Force. Although it doesn't sound threatening, the force has the Chinese and the North Koreans pissed off, and the region teeters on the brink of war. Into this political hotbed, the third echelon dispatches you. Splinter Cell operative Sam Fisher.
Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Your objective? Defuse the situation and save the world. What else is new? Your mission will take you from Peru to New York to Tokyo and back. If you're familiar with previous Splinter Cell games, you'll feel right at home. If you're a rookie, here are the basics. Fisher is undetectable when he crouches in the shadows and keeps quiet. If you're in a corner and a guard comes by, he won't see you, so there's no need to start blasting. But when everything does go to hell, don't panic. Seek out a hiding spot and visit your happy place until things quiet down. Next, get acquainted with your equipment. Your goggles give night and thermal vision, and also an EMF setting, with which you can spot electronics. Another upgrade is the EEV attachment for your binoculars, which lets you connect to computers wirelessly. Another new gadget in Sam's goodie bag is a combat knife. This may very well be the sharpest tool in the shed.
Because as soon as you close, you gotta take a decision. You can interrogate, you can kill if you want, or you can just knock out if this is a non-lethal mission.
Playing Chaos Theory, you will hold the fate of many men in your hands. While one trigger button will put your captive down for a nap, the other will put him down for good. When Fisher's equipment people sent away for the new Ginsu knives, they got some bonus toys too. The SC pistol now packs OCP technology that can set lights and security cameras on the fritz. Certain aspects of the gameplay have also gotten a facelift.
In Chaos Theory, we're introducing another new game mode, which is the co-op. Co-op is a mission-based campaign where two rookie agents are going on a side story of what Sam Fisher does. To rely on a partner to achieve a mission is another way of playing Splinter Cell, so you cannot do it by yourself anymore. You gotta trust a partner.
You got all that, Grunt? Good. Keep your ears open and your trap shut, and you might make it home. After the break, we'll walk you through the opening level and get you acquainted with the game.
Go big or go home.
The next generation of racing storms into the Pacific Northwest.
This is what drifting's all about.
Formula D Seattle. Return September 10th at 7 p.m. only on G4.
Uh-huh. Welcome back to Cheat, the show that ran Black Ops and Nam. The next level we're targeting with our Eye in the Sky spy satellite is the deadly Lighthouse of Death. Nervous? Good. Fear is your friend. In the Lighthouse mission, Sam's investigating an American engineer being held by Peruvian separatists. Stupid separatists. The primary objective is to contain information within the rebel camp. But Sam must also scan the SCC codes on 5 hidden crates.
Nice gun that you got here. Well, thanks.
In this walkthrough, I'll show you how to make your way around the stronghold and find the crates.
Hey, I choose that.
The first crate is at the end of a long hallway lined with a Donkey Kong level's worth of barrels. The next is in the cellar. Just take out the light over the stairs, then pierce the generator and look left. Now, let's talk strategy. When you reach the interrogation area, knock out the light over the ramp. When a guard comes to check the light, sing him a lullaby. Next, sneak up on his pal inside the cell. Approach him from behind and apply a chokehold, courtesy US of A. If you've been itching to test your thermal goggles, Tent City's the perfect place. You'll be able to see right through the tents and pinpoint the bad guys. Wait for the guard in the nearest tent to talk to his comrade.
You best get going then.
When he returns home, use your combat knife to open the back of the tent and pop in to say hello.
I'm looking for Lacerda. He's been behaving very badly lately.
This is also the location of crate number 3. Use the OCP to disable the lights, then swoop in and whoop ass. The goods are in the tent next to the generator. The fourth crate isn't too far from the camp. Again, take out the light with the OCP, then move in and scan it. Be sure to eliminate the guards on your way out. The last crate is conveniently located on your way to the lighthouse. Knock out the light to lure the guard. When he comes by, knife him and finish off his friend. Check behind these stairs and you'll find the crate. Mission accomplished. Since cheaters like nothing more than showboating after a win, here's a spectacular way to end the mission. Once you reach the top of the lighthouse, hang on to this ladder and observe the guard. When he's in this position, move up to the platform, making sure not to cast your shadow on him. Now, head for the switch over yonder. Use the Y button to hop over the railing and wait for the guard. When he gets close, use the A button to grab him and send him to his death. Now, do a little dance and get ready to dust off.
Damn, we killed the hell out of that guy, huh? And there's a lot more where that came from. Next, we'll be taking the French for all their francs. Or is it euros? Well, who cares? They're French.
Okay, your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to infiltrate a bank, gather info on an arms deal, and steal 50 million in French government bonds while making the whole thing look like a robbery. Sounds fun, right? It is. But you gotta have game, so get your cheating caps on. The insertion point is crawling with patrolling guards. It's best to eliminate them before entering. Next, head to the roof, disable the seal on the skylight, and rappel down. Inside, you'll find that you're surrounded by lasers. Use your EEV on one of the computers to disable them. Next, interrogate this guard who forgot about the you snooze, you lose rule. If you capture Sleepyhead, you can bypass the retinal scanner. If you kill him, you'll have to hack it. When you get by, head down the hall, shoot out the exit sign, and take out any guardage. Now, the party's heating up. There are 3 rooms, and you'll have to hit an enable access switch in each one to open the vault. The first switch is in the treasurer's office on the ground floor. The other 2 are on the second floor in the security room and the president's office. To get into the treasurer's office, either eavesdrop on a repairman, or just hack the door. Inside, make sure to kill the lights. There is an energy crisis, you know. Plus, you'll keep the camera from detecting you. Raid the cabinets for documents and hit the switch. To get to the second floor, you have to go through a duct in the janitor's closet. Don't inhale any of the cleaning products, as you need to be clear-headed for the sake of national security. Before opening the door, use the OCP to take out the camera behind you, then crawl to this restroom. Switch off the lights as soon as you get inside. The guards have very small bladders, and they're always going in there. In front of the restroom is a security room. Disable the security camera and cross the room. Shoot out the light over the window, then hack into the computers. When you're done, head upstairs. The reception area is full of lasers, but they're extremely cheatable. You can either shimmy along the left wall, or you can just grab a guard. The guards are equipped with laser-negating devices, so throw one on your back to cross the room safely. Do the same in the next room.
In the waiting area, shoot out the light so the camera doesn't spot you. When a guard comes to check out the noise, eliminate him. Move to the right and sneak in. You should be able to grab the guard. Hack into the computers in this room, and you can take out the cameras for the rest of the level. Hit the access switch and head for the president's office. With the cameras no longer adding 10 pounds, the rest of the level is cake. Hack into the computer and hit the access switch. The vault door is now open, so head back to the treasurer's office. If you haven't yet, stop stalling and take out the guards in the security room. You're gonna have to deal with them eventually. To open the vault, you must gather the gear in the safe deposit box. Put the telemetric pick on one lock and manually pick the other one. The trick to picking both locks is holding the pick in position until the red light turns green. Move too soon and you have to start again. Once the deed is done, blow the vault to cover your tracks. Head for the computer in the back and download the intelligence you need for the primary objective. Now grab the money and head for the exits. As you extract, you'll face an unavoidable laser grid, which will trigger the alarms.
Lasers inside the vault door.
If you've done your homework and eliminated all the guards, it shouldn't be a problem. But if you've been a bad boy, you'll have to shoot your way out. Now take your $50 million and head back to the insertion point for extraction.
You know, I bet the man wouldn't notice a few mil missing from all that loot. In fact, excuse me, because I feel a shopping spree coming on.
When America needs a hero. When freedom stands alone. Let us join Special Agent Bob and Secret Agent Steve, two of the finest official unofficial splinter cells.
What are you doing?
I love that noise.
Beep, beep. Beep, beep. Just get down there and grab the files.
Okay, just don't drop me this time.
At least get the... Just stop it! I don't know why the goggles make noise.
All I'm saying is that if we're supposed to be stealthy, why do our goggles make sound? And why do they glow?
I don't know!
On, off, on, off, on. It's cool. I deserve that.
Stay tuned for the continuing adventures of Bob and Steve.
Welcome back to Cheat, the show that says you can't handle the truth. Whew, I don't know where that came from. We're looking at Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, and now I'm going to break you up into pairs so you can explore the game's new multiplayer. So everyone grab a buddy and start blasting bad guys. The game's brand new co-op mode takes multiplayer to a whole new level. There are so many enemies, you're definitely going to need some help. So if you have a friend, get him or her involved. Since there can't be more than one Sam Fisher, in multiplayer, you both play as third echelon rookies. The mission locations are similar to the single player game, but they're designed specifically for multiplayer teams. Yeah, yeah, I know, Lone Wolf, you like to work alone, but this time you have to get some help. Don't play well with others? Well, here are some tips and tricks to help you all get along. First tip, it's simple, do the training. Unless you've got insane intuition, you need to learn the tricks of your new tandem trade. The most important skills to learn are boosting your bud up onto ledges, using him as a human ladder, and naturally, tossing him at an enemy like a human missile. The OCPs they give the rooks aren't the same as Fishers. You need a direct line of sight to be effective. Nonetheless, it still works against the guards. Have one player use it to distract them, then have the second swoop in for the kill. Teamwork. Isn't it beautiful? You can also tag team security cameras. Since they're bulletproof, you can't shoot them. Well, I guess you can shoot them, but it won't do anything. Instead of wasting bullets, have one operative hide in the shadows and use the OCP to temporarily disable the camera. Then, have the second player rush across to a safe zone from which he can return the favor. There's no I in team, people.
Ready when you are.
Other moves in the game require the cooperation of both players. To rappel into a missile silo, for example, one player must act as anchor and guide his buddy down the shaft. This is also true for moves like the inverted hangover. In this maneuver, the descending agent must trust his partner not to drop him into hot water. perfectly executed, the inverted hangover is a thing of beauty and is very impressive to the ladies. One final piece of advice. Even if your partner turns out to be a noob, don't start yelling at him over your headset. The game has proximity audio, and the AI may detect you. What the hell was that? Instead, just calmly drive over to his house and punch him in the face. That's the spirit. On this next level, you can just take it easy and relax at a Japanese retreat. Of course, you have to clean up all the blood of the enemies that you take out on the way. In this mission, Sam is tasked with eliminating Milan Nadich, who's been implicated in Zerkezi's evil plan and may be leading a rogue faction of Displace International. After insertion, work your way to the courtyard. Use your EEV to scan the license plates and head into the old Showin. The easiest way to enter is through the building to the right. Climb through the window and squeeze into the ventilation shaft. The flooring is noisy, so walk slowly. Some walls on this level are paper, so avoid casting your shadow on them. Shoot out lamps where you can, and use your thermal to see into bright rooms. Go to the dining area and eliminate the guards. Go through the kitchen to the left and enter the practice yard. Inside, there are two guards and a civilian. Grab the near guard and sleeper hold him. Then, use the OCP as a distraction, and when the second guard turns his back, take him out. The civilian is harmless, but put him to sleep anyway. Now you're in the bathhouse. To eavesdrop on an important meeting, crawl into the shaft to the right and hunker down.
The boss is on his way and things are heating up.
The big chatterbox, Mr. Nadich, is your objective. After the meeting, go to the end of the shaft and wait. A pair of guards will exit from the front entrance, but a third will hang out. Wait for the coast to clear before going after Nadich. When you catch him, pull him through this paper wall in spectacular spy fashion. Interrogate him.
You're gonna make me cut your throat and look for the words inside your neck.
Then execute your objective. Return to the vent before the guards know what's happened. Wait for them to disperse, then take them out one by one. The vent shaft to the next area is behind the Golden Buddha. Oh, don't forget to rub his belly. Continue through the middle and new Showin. You'll know you're heading in the right direction as rooms become more modern. This clear glass door is the entrance to the new Showin. Shoot out the lights over the stairs and creep in. Take out the guards and seek out the supply closet. Squeeze into the ventilation shaft and you'll have access to the tea house. Wait on the roof as the story unfolds. There's nothing you can do to save Zerkezi or apprehend Shetland. If this frustrates you, drop down and take out the guards one by one. With your objectives completed, head to the extraction point. Good work, but we're not done yet. After the break, we'll take a sneak peek at one of the last levels in the game.
Mornings on Action Blast. It's a fight to the finish with Kaiju Big Battle.
This is it! Belly to belly suplex!
Sigma 6 and Beast Wars.
Maximize!
Action Blast. Mornings at 8, only on G4.
Hello, David.
How did you get in here?
That's not important now. Listen carefully. You have to watch Midnight Spank, G4's new block of late-night shows.
Why?
Because I can make everyone you've ever loved disappear, David. Disappear forever.
Oh.
Introducing Midnight Spank. Weeknights only on G4.
Go to G4TV.com. What you need, when you want it.
Next up in Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, we'll take you through the middle of a war zone. They may be crazy, but they're not liars. True to their word, North Korea has attacked South Korea, and Sam Fisher's got to clean up the mess. He's been sent into a war zone to retrieve data from the NDT. Making your way from the safe house to NDT is easy. Enter through the vent near the third propaganda spouting speaker, and it'll lead you to a ladder conveniently located right over the data drives you need to access.
Good. Now get that drive up to the room.
Sure. Getting into the room was simple, but getting out isn't. You'll have to wait until the guards blow the doors open, so make sure to stay far away from the blast. Cut through the guards, head up the elevator, and transmit the data. You didn't think it was going to be that easy, did you? Your revised objective is to eliminate all evidence of data collected by the plane.
Lambert, we have a problem.
In this new mission, you'll face a UAV, or unmanned aerial vehicle, which, if it sees you, will blow your ass away. Since that's not what you want, either use your sniper attachment to take it down, or the OCP to temporarily disable it. Go beneath the catwalk and disable one of the P3R stations. This will complete one of your opportunity objectives. Grab the cable and slide across to the next building. If you destroyed the UAV, this will be a lot easier. If you haven't, you'll have to time its sweeping patterns to avoid it. The second P3R is beside the railing. Use your EEV to disable it and clear out. Head for the head, and you'll find half the building missing. Lower yourself floor by floor and keep out of the UAV's sight. Jump across the next building and take out the third P3R. Work your way down the apartment building till you reach a restaurant. Head for the kitchen and locate the dismantled UAV to complete one of your objectives. This can be done covertly by using your EEV on the laptop while peering through the order up window. Finally, go through the ventilation shaft behind the bar to exit the area. Don't kill any of the South Korean soldiers or your mission rating will be screwed.
Jesus, Bishop, what did you do?
Go up the fire escape just past the tank and disable the fourth P3R. Then sneak past the soldiers and tanks until you reach the crash site. To the left of the pilots, there's a pipe from which you can reach a balcony. Once you get up, disable the last P3R and complete your opportunity objective.
Way to go, Sam.
Nice job, but it's not rest on your laurels time yet. You won't be able to retrieve the data, so you'll have to laze the target for an airstrike. If you're hungry for points, you can ace a hidden objective by picking up the fallen pilots and dragging them out of the strike zone. Your buddy Lambert will let you know when you've dragged them far enough.
All right, the pilots are safe.
At last, climb the scaffold, point your EEV at the wreckage, and wait for the big bang. Nice going there, partner. As a reward, I got you some exclusive cheat codes you can really use to turn up the heat. Just like in all previous Splinter Cell games, there are the Unlock All Levels cheat codes, and Chaos Theory is no different. I hope you all have your paper and pencils ready, because here they come. To unlock all of the game's 10 levels in the Xbox version, enter Co-op A22 Cool as your profile. That's not so bad, is it? Unfortunately, the PlayStation 2 version isn't as easy. In the main menu, press and hold L1, L2, R1, and R2. Then press square 5 times and circle 5 times. That's it. Remember, you heard these cheat codes here first. If you weren't able to write down all the codes in time, then visit our website at g4tv.com/cheat and copy them there.
We also have the exclusive GameCube code on our website. Until next time, I'm Chief Cheater Kristin Holt, and I won't tell if you won't.
Whoa, that was close.
I know.
Guys, what are you doing? You're playing video games when you could have a job creating them. With the right training, you could be an animator, a game analyst, or a game programmer. Make sure video games are a part of your future.
Train online for a career in game design. Call toll-free 877-558-2953. That's 877-558-2953. Call now.
Okay, cheaters. If you like blood, gore, and battling ancient malicious gods, then this week's show is for you. If you don't like blood, gore, and battling ancient malicious gods, then who am I kidding? Everybody likes that stuff. Stay tuned for our expose on God of War. Welcome to Cheat. I'm Kristin Holt, and today we're going Greek with the mythological God of War. In this game, you play as Kratos, a Greek warrior who's so angry he hurls himself off a cliff in the first scene. Of course, since falling Greek guy would be a pretty crappy game, Kratos resurfaces and you must help him reap his revenge. We asked game director David Jaffe how old Kratos got so PO'd in the first place.
Now there is no hope.
And Kratos cast himself from the highest mountain in all of Greece. Death would be his escape from madness.
The basic plot of God of War has you taking on the role of Kratos, who is a Spartan warrior. And as he falls, he starts having this flashback, this recollection of several weeks before he decided to kill himself. And that's actually what the game is, where you're playing this flashback of those last 3 weeks.
Ares! Destroy my enemies, and my life is yours.
That desperate call for aid would come to haunt Kratos for all his days.
By the gods, what have I become?
And embedded in that flashback is the search of Pandora's box, which is the only weapon capable of allowing a mortal to kill a god. And Kratos' goal is to use Pandora's box to find and kill Ares, who is the god of war.
Zeus, do you see now what your son can do?
We have all of the main gods. We have Zeus and Ares and Athena. We have these oracles all over the game. They're very sexy.
There is a mini game that's within the first level. It involves twins. I put it together, and it's kind of a sex scene.
Come back to bed, Kratos.
And it was just like a fun little side game. I think that when players play it, they'll be like, that's really fun, and it's cool. It has no reason, but it does bring the story out and develops the character.
I'm not a big fighting combo guy. I don't like fighting games all that much. All I said was, give me brutal, give me violent, and I want it to be fun. And they are the ones who sort of brought the heart and the depth of the fighting system. They just took it to this next level where you were doing these amazing combos and every combo could be linked together or every move could be linked together into a different combo. And you really had this freedom to experiment. And that was really all them. I wanted to bring interesting puzzles into the game. So we racked our brains on the design side. It's like, let's come up with actual puzzles like back in the days of Infocom, you know, back in the days of the old games when you were growing up in the 70s and 80s, and you had a puzzle and it took some time to figure out. For example, we have a pressure plate puzzle in the game where you stand on it, a door opens, and you run off the pressure plate and the door closes. So the puzzle becomes, how do I figure this out? So it was the idea of sort of forcing the player to actually think to get through these puzzles versus just sort of going through it by numbers. We have some challenges where Kratos has to push this guy up a hill and he's in a cage. And you basically have to push him to the top of the hill where you sacrifice him in this giant fire pit.
Gods on high, save me from this barbarian! Please, please!
The whole game, again, it begins as this very tragic tale and it ends as this very tragic tale. But in between the whole things, there's this great big high adventure, hyper-violent, overly sexual, adult action adventure game. So that's kind of God of War in a nutshell.
Ares, you will die for what you did that night.
Wow, sex, revenge, human sacrifice, and puzzles. Who could ask for anything more? Well, you probably. So after the break, I'll show you which weapons to upgrade. Stick around.
What if someone told you you could take what you love doing and change your whole life? If you're ready to take your passion for gaming and really make it pay, check out a bachelor's degree in game and simulation programming from DeVry University. Be the one who develops the next blockbuster game or creates the simulations used for military training or crime scene reenactments. And in DeVry's program, you'll be set up to do just that. With our unique mix of hands-on learning and individual attention, so go to DeVryOnYourWay6.com and get started by downloading 4 free video game demos from Vivendi Universal Games. Don't change your game, just step it up. Call 866-5DeVry6 or log on to DeVryOnYourWay6.com for these free video game demos. DeVry University.
Tennis.
rated E for everyone.
Whoa, that was close.
I know.
Guys, what are you doing? You're playing video games when you could have a job creating them. With the right training, you could be an animator, a game analyst, or a game programmer. Make sure video games are a part of your future.
Train online for a career in game design. Call toll-free 877-558-2953. That's 877-558-2953. Call now.
Go big or go home.
The next generation of racing storms into the Pacific Northwest.
This is what drifting's all about.
Formula D Seattle. Return September 10th at 7 p.m. only on G4.
Welcome back to Cheat, the show that stole fire from the gods and gave it to man. And speaking of stealing, here's where to find all the power-ups and weapon upgrades in God of War. And don't forget my cut.
So, you think you can conquer the Temple of the Gods, do you? It's never been done, you know. Sooner or later, the Harpies will bring what's left of you back for me to burn.
Wow, that looks painful. Fortunately, you can avoid a similar fate by finding chests throughout the game. Good things come in these packages. Green chests boost energy, blue ones up your magic, and red ones contain experience orbs. They let you level up and become more powerful. Of course, you've got to upgrade judiciously. Start by upping your Blades of Chaos to level 2 and 3. That will make the monster mashing easier and keep you alive for bigger and badder things. Next, power up Poseidon's Rage and Zeus's Fury to level 2. You can make Medusa's Gaze a little stronger, but keeping it at level 1 won't hurt you either. It's better to save red orbs for Artemis's Blade. This big-ass sword will decapitate your enemies in a single blow. Continue to alternate your power-ups between these weapons and magic until you receive the Army of Hades.
I offer you the Swords of Hades itself.
This ability lets you conjure up a coalition of Hell's minions and will be a lot of help when fighting Ares. Ever wonder why guys like chests so much? Well, it's because they contain goodies like Gorgon eyes and Phoenix feathers, of course. Sacrifice 6 of these items and you can extend your life or maximize magic. Here's an insider's guide to the best hidden chests in the city of Athens. Right after your encounter with Medusa, climb up the ladder where this guy is just hanging around. Get a running start and double jump your way onto this ledge to open a red chest. Then jump to the left to find another red chest. When you reach the top of this area, pull the ballista to the left to reveal a chest containing a phoenix feather. Turn the ballista around and aim it to the right to uncover 2 more chests which you can't quite reach yet. Head up to the balcony and stand on this brown ledge. Jump down and double jump across the way to receive your rewards. One of the hardest chests to find in the game is located on top of this roof. After defeating these minotaurs, break the corner of the scaffolding and leap down to find a well-positioned chest that holds a Gorgon eye. Collect all these chests and you'll be healthier, more energetic, and more powerful.
Whenever I get some fresh new powers, I go looking for a level boss to test them on. Knowing this, God of War's designers have included a big, mean minotaur you can use as a punching bag. If you know how to cheat him, that is.
Athens has no shortage of ass-kicking mythical creatures, but the undisputed champ has to be Pandora's Guardian. This beast stands 10 stories high and has 1,000 years of built-up frustrations. As one of Pandora's last protectors, this monster can inflict major damage to those who seek her powers. If he gets a hold of you, he will toss you like a rag doll. Fortunately, we found a few holes in the big guy's game. Stand in the lower part of the screen and jump when he pounds the ground. When his arm goes up, use the Lance of the Fury's aerial attack to damage his armor. Repeat this a few times and you'll eventually pierce his iron hide. After you score 5 critical hits, the Guardian will fall. Pretty dramatic, huh? As he goes down, run over and jump on top of him. Now it's Minotaur Mountain time. Ride him, cowboy! When your ride ends, fly like the messenger god Hermes to this platform. Once you're there, pull this lever to unleash a devastating blow. Time your jump to avoid the Guardian's rampaging attack, then repeat your offensive strategy. After 5 more critical hits, this guardian will tumble and you can get in another session of pro minotaur riding. The third round is all about being patient and jumping around to break his outer shell. When you have him stripped to the bone, unleash the most powerful attacks in your arsenal, or continue with our earlier strategy using the Lance of Furies to bring him down. When he finally succumbs, pull the lever one final time to punctuate your big win. Then, walk through the newly opened area to receive your reward, the Architect's Son's Head. Return to the Rings of Pandora and use the head to drain the water. Once inside, rotate the inner ring so it lines up with the turn wheel in the middle chamber. Next, spin that wheel to reveal the final outer chamber. Now, make like Pat Sajak and turn this last wheel to reveal a long tunnel with bloody spikes on the wall. Go to the end and push the two crystals together for a one-way ticket to the Cliffs of Madness. I hear they're quite breathtaking this time of year.
Boy, that Minotaur was just a big bully, huh? Get it? Bully? Because he has the head of a... Oh, come on! That's hilarious! Why do I even try?
Hey everyone, I'm Layla Cayley and this is The Feed. Our top story, Apple is considering a plan to rent movies through the iTunes Music Store. Watch for an announcement at Apple's Worldwide Developers Conference later this year. In gaming news, Wii leaks are flying thick and fast. Nintendo's new console will have Wi-Fi capabilities and offer online play for no extra charge. And at the movies, Bing Rames, Mina Savari and Nick Cannon have been cast in a big budget remake of George Romero's Undead Chomper, Day of the Dead. Designer Philippe Stark, actress Victoria Principal, and Superman director Bryan Singer have all signed up for spaceflights on Virgin Galactic. The cost? A mere 200,000 bucks per person. That's a lot. And finally, Chinese Boy Scouts will spend this summer scouring the internet for illegal copies of songs and movies. For more news and info, visit us on the web at g4tv.com, the only source for all the stuff you care about. I'm Layla Cayley, and you've just been fed.
At what point does a car do more than take you from point A to point B? When does it come to life? When does it become your co-conspirator? When does a car become more than just a car? Introducing the all-new 268-horsepower Toyota Camry. It's time to move forward.
Be brilliant with E-Trade's exclusive intelligent lending optimizer. Be insightful and explore multiple lending possibilities in seconds. Be in command and make sure you get the most value of every dollar you borrow. In other words, be master of your domain.
Oh, there's my earring.
The intelligent lending optimizer. Only at E-Trade.
I had taken 3 years of electronics courses in high school, but when I finished, I knew I really wanted a career in computers. A friend told me about ITT Tech. I spoke to a representative and signed up just 2 weeks after graduating. It was definitely the right thing to do. While attending ITT Tech, I was hired by a computer and technology consulting firm, and with the skills I picked up at ITT Tech, I believe I'll be able to adapt to new technologies and stay current as the future unfolds. I now work as a manager of information technology. My parents couldn't be prouder. They're happy that I'm taking my career to new heights. I'm really quite happy. Technology is the future, and that's where I want to be.
We are educators helping people build a foundation for the rest of their lives. ITT Technical Institute, education for the future. To find out more, call 1-800-327-1172 or visit us on the web. Get an education that can help you reach your goals. ITT Tech has information on financial aid programs for those who qualify. Call 1-800-327-1172 to apply.
What is it, Bob?
You can take
this
job.
Yeah, you take this job and shove it. Blah, blah, blah. So you're quitting, huh?
Yep, I'm gonna be my own boss.
I bet you're gonna be your own boss. What do you know about being your own boss, Mr. Entrepreneur? Gonna buy a business, start from scratch? How about startup money?
Whoa.
Even know where to get startup money?
My brother.
Got a plan, a program, a mentor, Bob? You can't be your own boss without them.
I can't?
You're pathetic. You need Entrepreneur of the Year nominee, Bruce A. Berman's book and CD. It's called I Got Here, You Can Too. Wanna be rich, Bob?
That's the idea.
Then you gotta buy his book and CD. It shows exactly how Berman made a fortune being his own boss, and you can too. Wanna start making money now, Bob?
Sure.
Thanks, guys. I'm Bruce A. Berman. If you wanna make $5, $10, even $15,000 a month right now from the comfort of your own home, then you don't have to buy my book. I will give you a free copy of my book and my Making Money CD. Together, they're over $100 value. This limited time offer is available only on my website below. So go to my website now.
If you're like me, you hate puzzle levels. I want to blow some things up. Here, our research team got the answers to the toughest traps.
Kratos, the journey forward is perilous, but one you must complete if you are to have any hope of saving Athens.
To save Athens, Kratos must journey to the Desert of Lost Souls to recover Pandora's box, a powerful weapon hidden deep within her temple walls, high atop Kronos, last of the mighty Titans. To obtain this power, however, he must solve the many puzzles of the architect. Happily, most of the puzzles in Pandora's temples are for ages 3 to 10 and can be solved easily. Some of them, however, are a real pain. In the Challenge of Atlas, a large spiked wall will roll towards you after you acquire the Shield of Hades. Easy to avoid, if your Blades of Chaos was strong enough. Instead, use the Blades of Artemis.
You have learned to use the Blades of Chaos well, but they alone will not carry you to the end of your task. I offer you the very blade I used to slay a Titan.
The Blades of Artemis are perfect for this close quarters combat. With short strides, you'll be able to make sure these fallen legionnaires stay fallen. Your next puzzle takes place in the Cliffs of Atlas. Here, you have to defeat all the monsters before you're given a one-way ticket to Hades. Don't waste your time going after the sirens. Just target the magic legionnaires first. The best way to beat them is to break their shields, then attack with everything you've got. Be careful. When the floor starts to buckle underneath you, it's about to split open, so stay alert and get moving. After you tackle all the legionnaires, you can focus all your energy on the sirens. When you defeat them, you'll get the Handle of Atlas as a reward. The deadliest puzzle you'll face here also appears to be the easiest. In the Cliffs of Madness, just move the big block to the next room before the spikes get you. No problem, right? Wrong. First, pull the stone out far enough so you can dive behind it without losing time. Then, wait until you're at full strength and kick the thing over. Done correctly, the stone should be perfectly aligned with the door to the next chamber. Give it another good kick, then a medium kick to get it past the turn area. After one final strong boot, you'll be able to double jump your way to the top where you'll find the Necklace of Aphrodite. There. Now doesn't that beat figuring things out for yourself?
Okay, now can we get back to the brain bashing? Here, I'll tell you how to defeat Ares, the god of war himself. That's right, I ain't scared of nobody.
You are still just a mortal. Every bit as weak as the day you begged me to save your life.
I am not the same man you found that day. The monster you've created has returned to kill you.
As if Kratos' day wasn't tough enough, at this stage he's gotta kill the god who created him. It's definitely personal as Kratos and Ares duke it out. There's good news and bad news in this battle. The good news is you can replenish your energy by hitting Ares and causing health and magic orbs to burst from his body. The bad news is you're gonna need every one of those orbs to win. Use the Army of Hades to score hits on his holiness and watch out for his big ass hammer. Believe me, he wants to smash more than your thumb. When you've drained enough of his energy, Follow the button commands on the screen to deliver the final blow. In true cheat fashion, once you beat Ares, he'll start fighting dirty by sucking you into a whirlpool.
Kratos, what's happening?
Where he'll try to kill your whole family again by summoning a gang of thugs that look just like you. Sneaky, I like it. Your evil twins want nothing more than to increase their individuality by stamping you out. Use any weapons or magic you have to protect your fam and shake off anybody who tries to ride without paying. To replenish your magic, grab an armful of imposters and unleash more Army of Hades on them. Keep an eye on your family's health, too. If they start to look a little bedraggled, give them a big hug to heal them up. Like you, your twins are tough, so don't be afraid to use your Rage of God powers if your meter's full. You can use unlimited magic on these pretenders if you raised Blades of Chaos to level 5, so don't be shy.
The battle was not over. The gods, it seemed, had a final gift for Kratos.
Ares' big attack this time is causing pillars of rock to rise from the ground. It's a neat trick, but keep your distance from the big redhead, and it's not too dangerous. At this point, you're basically in an all-out brawl with the God of War. As long as you get more hits on him, you'll come out the victor. You know what they say, the bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Remember, Kratos, it was I who saved you in your time of greatest need.
I haven't forgotten, Ares. I remember how you saved me.
You'd think after beating Ares, Kratos would get to sit down for a minute. Well, after the break, you'll discover that this battle's only heating up.
Welcome to subliminal advertising. Please do not blink. Advertising complete.
So, where do you think this guy should move?
I'd say this way. And let's make sure that sound effect we used in the last level fits in here, too.
This one?
Yeah.
You know, I'm so glad I got into game design. It's cool to be able to create the kind of games that we play.
I know what you mean. And the training at Collins College takes less time than most people might think.
Can you believe we get paid to do this?
For a complimentary DVD, call 888-823-0999. Operators are standing by. That's 888-823-0999. Call now.
Wheels worth of cheesy goodness. That's snacking strong.
Hello, David.
How did you get in here?
That's not important now. Listen carefully. You have to watch Midnight Spank, G4's new block of late-night shows.
Why?
Because I can make everyone you've ever loved disappear, David. Disappear forever.
Oh.
Introducing Midnight Spank. Weeknights only on G4.
Go to G4TV.com. What you need, when you want it.
Welcome back. After defeating Ares, a mini-game challenge is unlocked for Kratos. And I wouldn't be much of a cheater if I didn't tell you how to beat him, would I? Enjoy.
You have done well, Kratos. Though we mourn the death of our brother, the gods are indebted to you.
Yeah, great news, goddess. But the real reward for beating this game is that the Challenge of the Gods is now open for business. You have to complete 10 challenges set forth by the gods. Most of them are beatable with some practice, but the last two require an advanced degree in fast reflexes. Chamber 9 pits you against 2 satyrs and a Cyclops Desert King. I know. You could kill a Cyclops Desert King with a slingshot if you had to, but this time you're on the clock. You have 2.5 minutes to kill 4 Cyclops, so timing is essential. Don't waste time going after the satyrs. Instead, concentrate on the big one-eyed sucker. Cyclone of Chaos in the air inflicts maximum damage in minimum time. I say throw caution to the wind and dive in. The Desert King has a few quick attacks, but you can duck them by watching his arm movements. Right before he goes into his charge, he'll slide his hand over the ground. This is his little way of politely informing you he's about to kill you. I suggest you dodge his attack by rolling out of the way. The Cyclops also tips his hand just before he attacks. When he's about to strike, he raises his sword real nice and high so everyone knows to get out of the way. Watch for these telltale signs and you'll pass this test with flying colors. In room 10, you'll have to kill many satyrs and cerebus seeds to raise this platform to the top. The more creatures you kill, the higher the platform goes. The toughest kills are the satyrs because they can block your attacks and knock you off the platform. The best thing to use against them is Apollo's offensive in the air. This makes you difficult for the satyrs to grab hold of and also allows you to go on the offensive before you come down. When the platform gets too crowded, clear the area with an aerial Lance of the Furies attack. And if you find yourself pushed to the edge of the platform, hit R1 repeatedly to unleash Hermes Fury. This quick dash attack will lead you back in the center of the battle circle. After several minutes of non-stop button mashing, the platform will reach the top. At this point, rush forth to reap your reward. Alternate costumes for Kratos when you start a new game. Now you can play as Chef of War, Bubbles, Tycoonius, Dairy Bastard, or Ares Armor. All these outfits have different strengths and weaknesses, so choose carefully. Personally, I like Dairy Bastard because he bashes people with milk cartons and walks around with his udders out. There's also a special and humorous Easter egg that can be found high atop of Mount Olympus. Here, you'll see two monuments of Kratos' defeated foes, Pandora's Guardian and Ares. They won't divulge their secrets without a fight, so just beat it out of them to reveal a secret message. No, it's not a math puzzle or some coordinates to a far-off land, but a toll-free number where Kratos and David Jaffe will congratulate you for deciphering their secret message. Now, let's give Kratos a call. Hello?
Who are you?
Hi, this is Kristin from Cheat.
Go away or I'll kill you.
What? Hey, I just wanted to let you know I discovered the Easter egg in your game.
What game?
You know, God of War.
I do not know what you are talking about.
You know, when you break those two statues on top of Mount Olympus?
If I kill you, I will get help.
Hey, dude, I just wanted to know if I get a prize or something for figuring out your little secret.
No. Go away.
What? I guess he's got his panties in a wad. Well, we've lied and cheated our way through God of War, and the immortals never knew what hit him. If you're a little fuzzy on the tricks we covered, you can check out the Cheat Sheet Master Database at g4tv.com/cheat for all the strategies. Until next time, I'm Kristin Holt, the goddess of cheat.